I'm good to play. Let's burn some dragons? No, wait, what are we doing? Which campaign is this?
Which campaign is this? Where am I? Things I tell myself on a daily basis at this point.
Well, Clay, you're a DM of 6. I play in 2.
I know.
Yeah,
you're actually
only
play one of them with me.
I'm sorry, John. I'm sorry for you.
Can't remember the one session that you had with me?
Wait, with you? Do I have a session with you?
I think you need a doctor.
Man, dude, I'm so exhausted from chemistry. Well, not really. I'm not that exhausted today. I actually have some energy. So we should have some fun. But chemistry being chemistry is chemistry.
It can be fun, but... Yeah,
well, yeah, it can be fun, but, you know, 3 hours of lab on top of my other 3 hours of classes, 4 hours of classes, it gets to you real good, especially when the fucking teacher won't turn the goddamn heat down.
Oh god, too hot and start falling asleep.
Exactly. I don't have a jacket, I wear a t-shirt. I literally wear a t-shirt, and it's like, what, 20 degrees outside? Actually, in Fahrenheit. 4 degrees Celsius, which is like 43, I want to say? 44? Something like that?
Yeah, my stepmom's like that with the heat. She turns it up to like 90. It's like, what the fuck? It doesn't need to be 90. Turn it down to like 65, 70. Mm-hmm.
Or, 72. Yeah, 70. 68. That's good for me.
My thing is, I like sleeping in the cold. So same. It's like, okay, my pillow and blanket are cold, but I'm gonna go right to sleep. Leave me alone.
Yeah, same, dude. I like, even sometimes in the winter, I literally open my window so I can fall asleep. Dead cold in my room, like permafrost.
See, the furnace is in the attic here, and it's right above my room, so whenever that thing is on, it turns my room into an oven.
Oh, Jesus.
I wish my room was an oven.
Yeah, that's because...
fucking
cold.
That's because you're dying from hypothermia, Clay.
Yeah, well, thankfully that is changing. It is currently... It is currently 58 degrees, apparently. And apparently we're supposed to stay in the 60s all day tomorrow.
Oh, nice.
I'm going to be walking around in shorts and a t-shirt.
Sounds good.
Here it's supposed to be like in mid-40s, maybe. Which I'm kind of glad, because Monday was like -1 out. The -20 wind chill. No, thank you. Don't worry about
it.
It's like
30 here all week.
Yeah, no, We almost hit single digit here on Monday.
Ha! Been in single digits. Cause Celsius. Ha ha! Fuck Fahrenheit, it's a stupid system and you should feel bad for using it.
Just for that?
Get mad at freedom units, bitch.
You get a hill giant belt instead.
Oh, Clay, don't! Are you kidding me?
Damn.
Fuck God.
No, he's fucking with you. It's actually a girdle of gender change.
I will drink it and then kill myself.
It's a girdle. Are you gonna drink
a fucking potion?
Tell me how you're gonna drink a
potion. I will drink it and I will kill myself. My statement stands.
Your statement
does stand. I will not change it.
Your statement does stand. If you somehow manage to drink a belt, it would probably kill you.
Good luck putting it down your throat, that's all I'm gonna say.
Also, what the fuck is a gurgle? I've never heard this word before in my life.
Girdle.
Your belt.
Girdle?
Yes, a girdle.
Yes.
Girdle.
Yes.
Never heard this word before in my life.
I mean, considering English isn't your first language, I assume, probably not surprising.
There's a lot of words. Yeah, there's a lot of words that I haven't heard in my life.
Just another word for belt.
Yeah, that's
why use it. So just fucking say
it's,
belt.
It's the old timey word for belt. Like it's the super old timey word.
They were also typically a lot thicker than a belt, per se, if I'm not mistaken.
What the fuck ever, man? I don't fucking care anymore. Girdle.
But you should. We're teaching you valuable English words.
Listen, valuable and English should not be in the same sentence.
Alright. And for that, we're knocking it down from hill giant to non-existent.
I'm kidding. It's jokes. It's just jokes.
No, it's not. It was only jokes
until the belt went away. Yes, Tyson. Thank you for outing me. I appreciate that.
Gotta go after it.
Thank you for making me talk for baiting me into talking at the fucking ceremony or whatever the fuck. Bitch.
Okay, can we?
All right.
We should stop talking before we dig. Before I dig myself into a deeper hole.
Well, you've already succeeded in that front. So, I talked with Tyson about this a couple of days ago. The fuck are you doing, bot? Why do you keep doing this? It plays random shit. It just occasionally plays random shit that isn't in my playlist.
Do you want this? Nah, fuck you. I'll pick what I want.
Good old auto play.
Learning. Run.
Why are you like this, bot? You had one job. So, I talked with Tyson about this a couple of days ago. Regarding the discussion that he had with the Storm Giant, as far as a time frame is concerned on when the Giants will be ready to march against Tiamat and the army, the timing of the campaign is still relatively long, so I will get you an exact timing on when the Giants will be ready by next week, but just know that it's not going to be but for several more months, not a week.
Okay.
Because you do have lots of traveling to do, there's lots of time that needs to be used and killed. A fair bit of the traveling is not done in the way that the traveling was handled before. It's relatively fast tracked traveling, but it doesn't change the fact that it's still there, which means going from point A to point B will be several weeks worth of travel. With that said and out of the way, last time on D&D, our group of adventurers had successfully dealt with the white dragon within Skyreach Castle. Upon reaching a deal of sorts with the Storm Giants there, the group of adventurers had succeeded in securing an ally of sorts for the war against Tiamat and the armies that would be approaching. It was at this point that our group of adventurers found themselves with, I believe it was a tiny raven, landing at their feet, a familiar voice speaking to them, and a parcel attached to the raven, which they found to be a scroll of teleportation. Upon using the scroll, our group of adventurers found themselves just outside of, I believe it was, just confirming the name of the place, just outside of Lord's Palace, So holy crap, I need to turn the music down a little bit on my end. 1 second. I just decided to get obnoxiously loud. Good old Final Fantasy.
Yeah, same here. It's only 1%.
What, same here with the obnoxiously loud part, or?
Yeah. After using the scroll of teleportation, the adventurers found themselves just outside of the Lord's Palace. They were greeted by a large crowd of people, among which Liasin, Antar Frun, several unfamiliar faces, a few familiar faces. And after being called up on why they were summoned back to Waterdeep on such short notice, so began the first council session. Shortly before entering the Lord's Palace, everything would have gone eerily quiet as a sound echoed throughout the winds, reverberated through the grounds, and just overall took a very large presence within the room. During this first session of the council, the group of adventurers informed the entire council of their journey so far. A few things were put into place and finally made sense, while some new questions were created. In the end, the group of adventurers were informed that the sound they had heard was what was known as the Drakehorn. This horn signaled, according to rumors, all of the dragons, and that when heard, they would heed its call. At the same time, the group of adventurers was introduced to two new theoretical members of the council, in the form of two representatives from the Council of Dragons, a silver and a bronze dragon. With the end of the council, with the end of the first session in sight, the adventurers were once again at the request of the Harpers and majority of the council, in that they now had two things that multiple people would like to see taken care of sooner rather than later. Rumors that Varum the White, the Worm Speaker in capacity of the White Dragon Mask, had been seen near Boreske Bridge. And then also an expedition to the far north and the Sea of Moving Ice. Our group was given some time to unwind, gather themselves. Everyone within the council was fully aware that it had been quite a while since any of these people had managed to enjoy the luxuries of a city. So, with that said, that brings us to the start of tonight's session. You guys have been given 2 weeks to do whatever you want with within the city of Waterdeep. After that, it is requested that you begin your journey, with you having the choice on whether or not you head north or whether or not you seek out Varum the White.
should probably find a tavern.
I think we're already in one.
I found one.
I think Gond had like a picture of it. I don't remember exactly what the lair was.
I did. Welcome, my friends, to the Yawning Portal. Let me very quickly populate this. For I do have NPCs.
Yes, the PCs.
So when do we want to start shopping, huh, team?
I feel like you should get Arcadius back here like as soon as possible, since he has a lot of.
I think we already did material. That.
You would have already.
Did we do that? Yeah, we did that.
Okay, yeah. I didn't remember if we did or not.
We got that done. Should we just dive straight into it?
Let's go shopping. I'm sorry.
It's fine. Just wait for Clay.
If you spend my tokens anymore, I will kill you. Because I know who's doing it.
Damn it, Oak.
Almost done. This was something I forgot to do beforehand. Alright. And then obviously we need the PC tokens, but...
Nah, those aren't important. We can leave those out.
All right. Welcome to the Yawning Portal, my friends.
Right, should we get a drink?
It depends. You want to get shopping? What time of day is it?
It was a rhetorical question. We're getting a drink.
It would currently be 1 p.m.
Sitting at this table.
So, Oz and Melkar, do you guys want to get some shopping done, or just probably relax for a little bit? I think we should get the selling out.
Wedge, get me a cold one, please.
There are no wenches here. Don't shut up.
You would watch as, after a few brief moments, a human woman, no more than 25, 26, I would say, brings over a mug and sits it down in front of you, Oak. Peering into it, you can see sort of a dark red alcohol.
Let's get a drink. once she's done pouring, obviously. I'm not just gonna, like, grab it while she's pouring, because that would be kind of stupid.
Somebody drinks cold orc blood.
As she finishes pouring, she looks around the table. Yes, is there anything I can get for the rest of you?
Well, thank you.
Something strong.
Coming right up, and she looks over towards you, Malkar.
Something strong as well.
Coming right up. You see her, she would disappear into the back after a few brief moments.
I'm chugging this thing. Downing it. 100% gone.
Feel free, my friend.
I've had a long day.
Long few months?
You could say that.
I think we should take today to unwind. Do our shopping tomorrow.
That was my plan. To relax for now.
I'll probably go shopping myself. If you guys need anything, I can grab something on the way. Do you?
No. Have fun your shopping.
After a few brief moments, you would see the female wench come back out with two mugs and one in each hand, and she sits one down in front of you, Ozan, and then sits another down in front of you, Malkar. Before
could you get me another one?
Yes, sir, absolutely. Would you like what they're having, or?
Sure.
Coming right up. See her disappear into the back. A few moments later, come back out with another mug and sits it down in front of you. In front of the three of you, you all, looking into the mug, see a deep candy apple red with a swirling orange mist.
Take a drink.
Yep.
Yeah.
How is it?
You get a taste of aged brandy with a hint of apple cider and a bit of spice. It goes down relatively smooth.
Is that what they call a fireball? Wait a second, no.
As all
what
three of you drink
again?
It...
What is a fireball again?
Fireball is... It's,
It's rum.
Cinnamon.
It's cinnamon. Cinnamon yeah. Whiskey.
Okay.
As all three of you take a drink, I need con saves from everyone that took a drink. Oak is fine.
Oh, I get a plus two. Yep. It's two, because they're within 10 feet of me.
Oak is fine.
Oath of... Aura of Protection. Devotion, I think?
Ozan is fine. Malkar is fine. Okay.
Yeah, Aura of Protection. Plus two.
Alright, so three of you are going to enjoy the rest of the day around the tavern, drinking, just enjoying civilization for the first time in many, many months. Otto, you yep. said you would prefer to do your shopping now?
Yes.
Okay. So, let's get into this then. What are you trying to do first? Are you trying to sell or trying to buy?
I'd probably try and sell first.
Okay. So, you would be spending most of your time around the markets for the rest of the day. In fact, for quite a bit of time. Remember, you guys have 2 whole weeks to do whatever you want, so 20 days. The item that you are selling, which is it going to be? I assume the Dagger of Venom?
Yes.
Okay. So, with that being determined, you can find a buyer for one magic item by spending one work week, so 7 of those 10 days, and 25 gold, which is used to spread word of the desired sale.
Okay, I'll do that.
So you can subtract 25 gold, and essentially we'll find out if you are successful in your sale attempts at the end of the first week, which gives you 1 week to buy items. With that said, subtracting 25 gold, can I get you to give me a persuasion check?
Sure.
Did the bot fuck up again? Or is it just really quiet? It's just really quiet. Okay, 22. So, and then okay. At the end of that work week, you would be able to find a buyer. The buyer, in fact, would offer you 6,000 gold pieces for the Dagger of Venom.
I'll take it.
So, you can subtract the Dagger of Venom, and you can add 6,000 gold. So, that's what he would be doing over the first week. Ozan, Malkar, and Oak, you guys essentially have a week to do whatever you want at this point. Which will catch us up with Tyler, and then you guys will have one more week. We're kind of montaging...
All right, the first...
We're kind of montaging your 2 weeks in the city. So if there's anything in particular you want to do, feel free to let me know. I'm just kind of montaging it.
I was just how I delete the Dagger of Venom. Is that, do I just delete it in the inventory or put it in the parcels?
Just delete it from your inventory.
Okay.
And just add your 6,000 gold.
On that night that we spent the first night relaxing, any of these people looking scholarly?
Within the tavern?
Yeah.
The only person that would probably catch your eye as far as a scholar of any sorts goes would be the woman sitting in the left-hand corner. She sort of, over the course of the afternoon that you're there, you get the feeling that she is well-versed when it comes to history, text documents, things of that nature. There's a very good possibility that she would know some things, depending on what you're looking to find out.
History and text documents. Is that what I'm looking for? I'm trying to have a talk with that. It doesn't hurt.
What's wrong, Ozan? You got an eye on someone? Before you taking a liking to one of them?
Takes a long sip.
I'm just going to try to expand my horizons a bit.
Yeah, you have fun with that.
bending all the things. Takes another very long sip.
Very paladin.
Rolls eyes.
So, just so that you can get a better view, the woman that you're approaching, this is what she looks like.
Mm-hmm. Do these robes, are they like her...
The robes that she's currently wearing, they are robes.
Okay.
And just at a first glance, you can tell that she is most definitely not from this region. Based on skin coloration, robes, the whole nine yards, it is very obvious that she is not from this particular region.
Alright. Does it give me, like, any insight as to, like, any, like, extra things, like, maybe wearing something that would signify that she's a certain religion or something like that?
Yes. You would notice a pendant around her neck. Based on text documents and things of that nature that you've managed to procure over time or glance at, you would get the impression that she would be far, far, far from the south in the more desertous region of the world.
You should offer her, like, an ice cream. She'd love that.
Is there even ice cream in this time period?
There's frost magic and milk.
Maybe easy. Maybe someone's come across it and
made it. Have you guys not seen Goblin Slayer?
Alright, shut up. I knew that's exactly where you were trying to go with it.
Yeah. Now that belt is getting farther away. So, fuck.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Oh, yes, how may I help you?
This may seem weird, but I sort of got the feeling that you may be one of the more intelligent types that may be a knowledge seeker, quite like myself.
Knowledge does, in fact, play a very important aspect in our world.
Would you mind if I took a seat?
Please, by all means.
Oak turns to the other two and says, "Oh, look at that smooth talker, he's already in."
Are you only talking to, Melter?
The other one, because your token is still at the table. Maybe you should move it then.
Well, fine, fuck you. I'm out of here.
He's quite the smooth talker, isn't he?
You see me sipping? Sure.
Snake is not trying to put game. Snake is not turning on game right now. That is just not what's happening.
There.
It doesn't matter that's happening.
I know. I came across a couple of books but they're incomplete, and I'm just looking for if someone may have some extra knowledge on the subject. I take out like my astronomy and astrology books. And, like, place them down. Have you any interest in the stars?
Oldest trick in the book. Nah, I can't hear that, so ignore that.
I can't say that it's something I've ever personally looked into, but... Well, all sorts of things in this world are fascinating. I can't see why that wouldn't be any different. I'm always willing to learn something new. for...
Knowledge is a great thing.
That it is. Perhaps a fresh set of eyes might be able to assist. What is it that you are finding incomplete?
This book, it only goes into... Well, it is a set of volumes, and I happen to only have found one. But there's a lot of stuff in here that piqued my interest. I wish I actually read the book so I could actually reference some things in that bitch, but... This is as far as D&D lore goes that I have the book.
Yeah. What is astronomy like in D&D? Tell me about the stars, Clay.
Yeah, tell us about the stars, Clay.
Clay, tell me a story.
Alright.
Papa Clay.
I quit after that comment.
God, I'm so not getting that belt later.
Just say an oak voice, make it easier. Maybe you'll convince him more.
So, here's the thing about astronomy in D&D.
Okay.
The stars themselves do have a larger connection to the world than they would say, for example, in real life. With there being multiple different realms, and then there being the material plane, the ethereal plane, things of that nature, the stars themselves are links between these planes. They're what holds everything together. So, yes, we do have constellations in D&D, much the same as we do in real life, but the constellations are that of symbols, fire, earth, water, things of that nature.
Okay, so they have a deeper relevance to the different plane of existences?
Correct.
Is like,
are they, okay, are they actual stars, as in they're giant balls of burning gas, or what? Are they just visual, magical...
That's
portals.
Like, no one is really sure of.
Okay, well, I know what's my next character now.
You
can't do this to me, Clay.
No one has ever really been close enough to a star to know exactly what it is. With the exception of gods.
Deadass now.
With the exception of
Deadass, gods. Deadass, that's my next character now. That's my next character now, dude. I'm not even kidding. I'm gonna make an astronomer, and his whole goal is gonna be to go see one of these stars up close.
I thought you meant like you're gone now. It's like, okay, I'm gone.
No. I'm gonna make a wizard who's gonna try and go to the stars. Alright, I'm done. That's me. In real life, too.
Oh, hey, it's Merlin. Now, wait.
Alright, I can work with this now. I can work with that information.
Yeah.
Carrying on this conversation.
To give you just a little bit more, gravity, physics, etc., things of that nature are all a universal constant, with the gods occasionally stepping in to muck things up, but they're usually the exceptions, not the rule.
Hold on, Clay. That's not true, because magic also fucks it up, too, because of teleportation.
Yes.
Yeah. Don't forget that.
But the real break in reality and the D&D version of astronomy isn't the lore, it's the actual, like, games mechanics themselves. By necessity, some things are simplified to the point of being ridiculous. So, as I said, for example, stars themselves are links between the various different planes of existence. Which means, theoretically, and this is all hyperbole, if you were to somehow manage to destroy a star that connected the material plane with the plane of fire, it is entirely possible that the plane of fire could spill over into the material plane.
and that's my other second character. Easy.
Fire Mancer.
So, no, not even close.
With a bit of actual information and lore on D&D astronomy, you can proceed.
All right.
That's actually really fun. Tell more stories, Papa Clay.
I'll kill you. Well, you see, in this book, it makes references to some planes that I am not familiar with. It goes over some of the more simpler planes, like the Fey Wilds or the Plane of Fire. But, what are all the planes again?
There's Ethereal, there's... What was the other one?
Astral.
There's so many planes. Plane, the Celestial Plane, or whatever it's called.
So, the planes of existence within D&D. The Material Plane, which is where you are.
Yeah.
Then you have the Transitive Planes, such as the Ethereal and the Astral Plane. Then you have the Inner Planes, which is the four Elemental Planes, Air, Earth, Fire, and Water. Then you have Outer Planes, such as the lower planes. The upper planes is essentially heaven, the lower planes essentially being hell. Then you have small extra dimensional spaces with their own unique rules, which are demiplanes. There's an endless number of them. Not an actual end to the number of planes of existence.
Yeah.
There's a few of them.
It goes over in this book a lot about the material planes, but it only makes references here or there, about the inner planes and the outer planes. I was wondering if you had any extra information on these, if you just wanted to share, go over ideas on how everything is connected together.
Yes, well, given my profession, it would best be suited to inform you with what little knowledge I have on the outer planes. The outer planes are where the angels and demons of sorts. Did the bot just fucking die? Yes, it did.
You committed suicide, yeah.
It's gone forever.
I heard you talking about planes, and it's like, yeah. Nope.
The bot literally just fucking died. Yeah, no, it went to the astral plane. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. I guess I'll just put some music on myself for the stream, at least. Alright, there you go, stream. We got some music on for you, at least. Don't worry. Alright, so, back to what I was saying. The outer planes themselves are essentially where celestials and demons dwell. Angels, things of that nature, dwell upon the upper planes, and then fiends such as demons and devils dwell within the lower planes. There has been several mentioned that they are connected to our plane, the material plane, more intricately than the inner planes are, in that it is much easier for one to cross over from the material plane to either the upper or the lower plane, depending on who you are as a person, I suppose is the best way to put it. For those truly righteous and chosen by angels or celestial creatures, they will find a much easier time transitioning from the material plane to either of the outer planes. Unfortunately, that same thing does apply to those that have been touched or have made deals with fiends or demons. Just as it would be very easy for a holy person to transition to one of the two planes, it would be just as easy for an unholy person to transition. This connection is supposedly tied to the very stars. If you're ever out at night, if you look to, I believe it would be the northwest from here, within Waterdeep, depending on the night, you might be able to see the angelic constellation. It is a sight to be seen. It's possibly one of the largest constellations that we've actually taken note of. I don't think there's a single set of stars connected more intricately than that one.
I see. That is very eye-opening in. Informative. Well, I thank you for your time on that subject. Now, the other thing, I noticed that you aren't someone who seems to be around from these parts.
You're not from around here, are you?
You seem to be someone who was raised more in a desert-like climate, environment, judging by your your garbs and your robes. What is that like? I have to say I'm intrigued to find out about other people's cultures, since I know very little about them in general. As I'm saying this, I am going to let down the hood to reveal what it is I am.
She screams and runs away.
It might happen.
Oh my. I think this is the first time I've seen one of your kind that wasn't trying to, well, kill everyone in sight. I suppose
yes.
The world does have all sorts of oddities.
There's exceptions to many rules.
You would be correct. I am most definitely not from this region. I am from a place called Schultz. I was sent here to investigate the goings-on in Waterdeep at the request of a merchant prince. Where I am from is the westernmost end of the Schulten Peninsula, which, if you know of the Trackless Sea, is the most southern part, off the coast of Kalimshan. Several years ago, during the Sundering, Schult was cut off from the mainland, forming an island itself. Unfortunately, because of that, trade is much more difficult now for my hometown. That's why I've traveled far to come here to Waterdeep, hoping that with the aid of magic, it will be easier to set up trade networks with my city.
Interesting.
Should you ever find interest in exploring Schultz, I would be more than happy to show you around if you ever find yourself there. Although, I do recommend that you be careful if you ever make your way there. It is a long journey, and it's always been remote and isolated, forming a mountainous jungle of savage beasts, hulking dinosaurs, and disease-ridden swamps. It's most definitely not for the faint of hearts.
Hmm. So how did you make your way here, if I may ask?
Very long, long, long. Several months of travel, and you see her hold up the symbol from her neck, and you watch as it begins to glow. A little help from above.
I see. Well, this has been informative and helpful. I thank you for your time. But I am quite exhausted after today, so I will be turning in now. Have a good rest of your evening.
And you as well, my friend.
Alright, and with that, I'm out. Guys, RP with the random. Guys, RP with the random.
Oh, how'd it go? Who's in?
Informative.
Are you guys gonna, like, you know?
I have left.
Did you at least get a number?
I know what he's saying. I cannot deal with this.
There was a dash on it.
Whatever.
Alright.
Wench, get me another one!
She's been bringing you beers all night.
Yeah, you bet she has.
How expensive are they each?
I'm gonna say, he hasn't asked. He's gonna love to see his tab.
300 gold. I would buy off.
So, with that said and done, Malkar, Oak, what would you two like to do for the rest of the evening? Slash, theoretically, the rest of the week.
Drink. Oh, for the rest of the week, I guess I want to go shopping as well.
Yeah, I guess I'll do my shopping.
Yeah.
Well,
at
some point.
Anything you want to do first, Oak, before shopping? Anything you want to do first before shopping, Malkar?
Okay, which NPC do you want me to talk to? Huh? Clay? Fess up?
Talk to an NPC.
Okay, you know what? No. I'll scan the tavern. Which one catches my eye?
Quick question.
Alright, you want someone that'll catch your eye?
Which one catches my eye, Clay?
I think the one near the barkeep, personally.
What, Lara Croft?
So as you sort of scan the bar looking around, you notice what appears to be a relatively young, possibly no older than 24, 25, female half-orc sitting alone at a table.
Okay. Oh, the half-orc? That looked like Elvis to me. I wasn't paying attention to
her. I
could tell
it was a half-orc because the fang. Sorry to cut you off, though.
Sure, I'll go up to her. Oh, pardon me, love.
Huh?
Way over.
Just stumbling all over the place. At this point, you're probably like 8 beers in.
Hello there. How you doing?
I've had better nights. How can I help you?
Well, I was looking around and I couldn't help but have you catch my eye. What's your name, love?
Sort of eyes you up and down for a second. Yagra. Yagra Stonefist.
Lovely to meet you, Yagra. I'm Okar. Just Okar.
So, Okar, what can I do for you?
Well, I just kind of came over here to chat, really. Nothing in specific in mind, just, I guess, how you doing? And all that.
It's been a rather boring night, to say the least.
Well, that's a shame. I've had quite the eventful day, personally. Not in the best way, though. Had a meeting with a counselor and all that crap.
I thought I recognized you.
Oh? Oak's like focusing his tiny brain, like trying to see if he remembers seeing her. But he's drunk, so he doesn't.
Yeah, you wouldn't remember seeing her even if you were sober.
Do you know me?
The whole town knows of you. The whole town knows of your entire group. You've been a major...
Wow, word travels real fast, doesn't it? Maybe I shouldn't be drinking like an idiot in a tavern. Wedge, give me another one!
And another round for me as well, please.
Put it on my tab. Should probably check what's I've gotten to. Nah, it's fine.
Well, that depends. What have you been drinking?
I have no idea whatsoever.
Might want to talk with Durnan about your tab at some point. He's usually pretty good about it. But...
Wench, something cheaper! For me, not for the lady, obviously.
You're interesting enough, and you might be able to help kill my boredom.
Well, I'm really good at killing things, so...
I assume so. You see her clear the table a little bit. She props an arm up on the table.
Oh, yes. Sits down. Props his arm on his arm on the table. I'm ready. Let's go.
Is it disadvantage because he's drunk? I'm just curious.
That depends. How many beers do you think you've had, Oak?
How long has it been?
The conversation between Ozan and Obaya, I'd say probably went over the course of like that was a deep conversation. That probably happened over the course of like half an hour. You guys walked in here at around 1 p.m.
Yeah.
There's no telling how long you were in here before he decided to go over there. I'm going to say it's probably close to 4, maybe 5 o'clock. So you've been in here for 4 or 5 hours.
3 hours. Yeah, four hours. Okay. I've at least had... I'm gonna say... So 3 times 4, 12. Times 45. I've had probably 13 or 14 drinks.
Yeah, you... You would most definitely be under the poisoned effect at this point, then.
Oh, no, I'm fine.
You wouldn't... Paladin!
No, this isn't 3.5. Nope.
You would be drunk.
I'll use 5 Lay on Hands to get rid of poisoned effect. I think I can do that, can't I?
You can.
I think it's only diseases, though. I don't know.
No,
healing and cure, cure the target of one disease or neutralize one poison. Yeah, there we go. Poison's gone, mate. I'm fine.
All right.
Congratulations, yeah. You're sober.
Congratulations, you're sober.
Oh, fuck. Wench, bring me another 2. Cheaper stuff.
Just keep mad.
Strong. Yeah, but strong.
Alright. Yeah, she'd be bringing it over. So, with her arm propped up on the table.
Yeah, I put mine in hers. Like, yeah. I put my hand, arm wrestling. Huh. Let's go.
All right, so contested strength check. 14. For quite a while, it's almost an even match. Then eventually, you would start getting the upper hands, and after several minutes of this just contested back and forth battle, you would eventually push her arm and her hand down onto the table.
Ha ha! Stands up. Throws his hands in the air. Oh, yeah!
That's not bad.
Let's go again. Let's go again. Come on. Now I'm propping my arm on the table.
Alright. You see her flex her arm a little bit, place it back down on the table. Holy. That looked like it was going to roll a 3, then rolled over to a 19.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Trust me, this is going to be my highest roll today.
Yeah, no, like, you get into the mindset of it this time, and just from the get-go, there's no breaks. You just slam her hand and her arm onto the table. You're almost positive that you probably broke the fucking table.
Oh, it's fine. I'll move, like, one of the empty mugs over to the part that it looks like it might be broken. It's fine, they won't notice. Well, you're quite strong yourself. Do you fight?
I get paid to protect a bunch of idiots.
Well, like mercenary work.
You could call it that.
Bunch of idiots. Well, like the count. Probably shouldn't say that. Never mind. I didn't say nothing. Who do you protect? Well, if you can't tell me, you can't tell me, but I'm quite curious, so I'll ask anyways.
You beat me twice. I can't see the harm in sharing a little information. Have you ever heard of the Zentarum?
Zentar? Have I, Clay?
You would. You would know that the Zentarum are probably one of the most treacherous and evil organizations within Waterdeep.
I have. Not many good things.
Yeah. You're not exactly wrong there, but... Well...
Yeah.
When you're paid to babysit someone from the group, and the pay is good... Thankfully, I just have to make sure that nobody kills him.
Well, I guess that's kind of fun. As long as plenty of challenges. It's too bad Zintar, though. Zintar's not exactly a good place to... hopefully you're getting paid well. That's all I want to say.
Oh, hey, Rogue. Takes a long Sorry, sip. I, don't have...
Very long sip. This might be a little too long.
Functioning.
He hasn't taken a breath for a second there. Nope, it's okay. Put some drink down.
This is 5e, not 4e. Unfortunately, the work is boring enough that... Quite honestly, this has been the most entertaining thing I've had happen in weeks.
That's not great. Is there like a fighting arena or something around here? Maybe something to keep someone busy. Why not try something like that? Or just go fight people. Actually, I shouldn't say that I'm a paladin. Don't fight people unless if they fight you. Or unless if they're assholes. Then it's okay to fight people.
Well, I have heard that they're talking about opening up an arena here within Waterdeep sometime soon.
I'll be curious to see
whether or not the competition is worth entering then.
It's a big city. Surely there's someone who could beat you. Definitely me. I know of three people.
If you're one of them, who's the other two?
Yeah, someone who could beat me. I can think of three people. I can't really beat myself because I'm not smart enough. Well, one, probably Ozen. Two, Onthar. And three, I want to say Malkar could beat me, but it really depends if I get the first hit or not. It's pretty, I'd say, yeah. Those three would probably beat me.
I heard that.
So you're saying old Renan over there wouldn't be able to beat you?
Who?
Come with me. You see her stand up from the table. You see her stand up from the table and go over to the bar.
What, this guy?
Renan, my new acquaintance here, thinks that he could take you in a fight.
That's quite a provoking way of saying it, but yeah, sure. Let's go with that.
Oh, Yagra, I've told you time and time again, my adventuring days are over with.
You used to be an adventurer.
That I did, my friend. I decided to pack it up, created the yawning portal here. I manage Undermountain.
Nice place.
Adventurers who wish to test themselves. Well, that well over there descends down.
Ah. Whoa, what does it descend to?
Well, that, my friend. Multiple layers of all kinds of nastiness. Hobgoblins, bugbears, ettins, giants. The last I heard, there was even a few trolls down there.
Oh, that sounds quite fun. I remember when we killed a troll. Oh, was it a troll or was it an ogre? It had like four arms and it was kind of greenish. And it like threw stuff. Did it throw stuff at us or did it hit me really hard? Or was that the shambling mandal or whatever? I don't remember. That sounds fun, though.
Sounds like you've had your own set of experiences, my friend.
Oh, yeah. I haven't been in a town in pretty much, like, a year, I want to say.
Yeah, it's probably close to that, actually.
Yeah, I've been out of civilization for a year, and it's been quite the mess. We tamed some lizards, fought some bullywogs, the frog dudes. Then we fought some giants. Then we almost fought a griffin. And recently we killed a dragon. And then there was also the armor that like tried to kill me, who I killed before they killed me. But then they did end up almost killing me. So then I didn't die. It's been a hot minute.
Sounds like you have quite a bit of experience underneath your belt.
But enough about me, tell me about yourself. Sounds like you were an adventurer too. I wanna know about you, mate. He takes a long sip from the drink, which he brought with him. Because this is oak.
There's not much to tell, unfortunately. Before you, for a better picture, everyone around here calls me Durnan. I gave up the adventure.
Durnan or Duran?
Durnan. D-U-R-N-A-N.
Yeah, yeah. Got it.
I gave up the adventuring life long ago. Bought the building, turned it into the yawning portal. though... No, it's better if I don't reveal anything too much.
Alright, what's the biggest thing you killed? Well, it's fine. Let's talk about, like, biggest thing you killed. Or the meanest thing you killed.
The meanest thing I've killed?
Yeah. If you say your wife, I'm a paladin and I might have to take you in, so don't say that. It's a common joke that I've heard too many times. Takes a long sip.
His wife is a goddess of pure evil.
That's alright. Adventuring lives, well, you don't really get the chance to settle down. No, but the meanest thing I've killed was probably... I forget his name, but it was an adult green dragon.
Oh, fucking hell. Well, a green dragon, how long ago did you kill it?
I reckon it's been close to 15 years now.
Damn. Elk's now, like, genuinely impressed with this man, and he's looking at him in a different light. As he takes a long drink from his drink, and asks for another one, because he has finished it. So, was that... Yeah, we've actually killed, like, I think it was an adult. Malkar, was the white dragon we killed an adult?
Pretty sure.
Yeah, we killed an adult white dragon real recently. So, I think, I feel
pretty
like
old
we're...
one at that.
Yeah, it was a dick too. It's like, I think his name, if I remember correctly, it was like, Heelgaz? Glasgow, probably. It was Glasheel, but it's okay. Glasheel or something.
We've both been drinking.
Yeah, we have.
Glasheel?
Yeah, Glasgow. Yeah, Glasheel. Yeah, that's it. That's the one. That's who we killed recently. May it rest in peace. Or not. He's kind of a dick.
That's quite an achievement in its own right.
Is it? I honestly don't know much about dragons, so...
It can be some of the most fierce creatures I've ever run into.
Is an idea. You seem knowledgeable. He's gonna take a seat at the bar now. I've completely forgotten about Yagra. He's taking a seat at the bar, and he's like, could you tell me more about, like, dragons in general, and, like, what I should know? Because it seems like I'll be fighting a few more in the future.
Oh, my friend, unfortunately, I've only ever really fought a couple. There's not too much detail.
A couple is more than me. Whatever you can fight, whatever you can come up with.
All right.
As he opens his notes, Marek thinks to himself, I must have hit a spot. I think I did a good. I think Ozan would be proud of me.
I don't think he would.
Alright, well, I've already
told
you.
I'm pretty sure Ozan went into the bathroom and never came out.
There's no upstairs here!
You
Where
went into
my...
the restroom, though. You took it.
No, he fell
restroom.
Down the toilet and he's trying to get out.
He's slithering down the toilet!
No, Ozan.
I am now a sewer snake.
Ozan. Tyson, here is a, like, multi-level view of the Yawning Portal. We're just gonna assume you're somewhere on the top floor just doing whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Oak is down there on the bottom floor at the bar.
Oh, hey, I found Matt Mercer already.
forgot about that.
I don't see Waldo.
Why the fuck is there a beholder in this bitch?
Don't question it.
Why is there a mind flayer? What the fuck is that table there?
Don't worry about it. It's the yawning portal. Alright, well, I already told you how I managed to kill an adult green dragon. I guess I can start with that.
Yeah.
Almost all dragons share the same thing. You'll need to be very careful of their presence in general. It's quite easy, no matter how battle-hardened you are, to find yourself fearing the choice to stare down a dragon. But each dragon, they're molded by their environments. With green dragons in particular, their breath attack is a poisonous gas. It can very quickly fill up this entire tavern, much less a battlefield itself. It would be best to stay as clear of it as possible, and only the hardiest are going to survive breathing it in. You'll want to be very, very careful if you find yourself staring down one of those. I notice you're a paladin, and unfortunately, my friend, no matter how much the gods say they'll protect you from poison, they can't save you from the poison of a dragon.
Yeah, I've noticed it's not really too great against poison, the whole the paladin thing, you know?
Starting to slur his words again. He's reaching that point again. Before he accidentally sobered himself like an idiot. He's been drinking a lot faster this time, so he's getting there real quick.
Then the other one that I could mention would probably be red dragons. To be honest, those are the most terrifying of them all, and I didn't manage to kill the one that I fought. In fact, that's how I have several of the scars that I still have to this day.
Pretty cool, though, so...
If you ever find yourself staring down a red dragon, may whatever god it is that you worship grant you the speed you need to move out of its way.
I probably won't. I'll probably get hit by it because I'm an idiot.
Well, hopefully you're not wearing your armor at the time, otherwise you will be cooked alive.
I heard toasted orc is delicious, so...
For that matter, though, going back to the green dragon, if you ever find yourself in a green dragon's lair, run. That's about all I can tell you, my friend. Green dragons themselves are difficult to begin with, but if you find yourselves in a green dragon's lair, well, that is a whole different issue. Not only will you be staring down the dragon, but you'll find that it'll take control of all of the plants and the vegetation in the area. It'll use the vines...
The vegetation?
Grab a hold of your legs, keep you from moving, so that it can enjoy its prey.
So, what, like the environment's fighting you too?
If you find yourself in a dragon's lair, yes. Even the environment...
Is that with all dragons? Or just green ones?
That would be with all of them, my friend.
Well, weren't we in that lair? Malkor! Weren't we in the white dragon's lair? Why didn't the environment fight us? Malkor! Oh, I think he fell asleep. Never mind. So we were in like a...
Malkor is nowhere to be seen, probably.
So,
I moved off to another, just started wandering the upper floors.
Alright, Oak doesn't notice it. He doesn't even realize that Malkar's not there, even though he's right there. And
I
should be obvious.
Study the beholder.
Anyways, right, yeah, there was like, we fought it, I don't know if it was its lair, actually. I have no idea. Never mind. Like, what would an ice dragon do? Ice dragon? White dragon do? It did ice attack, so I think it's ice dragon, but it's fine.
Well, unfortunately, I wouldn't be able to tell you as I've never personally fought one. But I have...
No.
Well, I've never personally fought one, but I have heard rumors.
Yeah. Oh? Do tell.
If you were actually in a white dragon's lair, you're rather lucky that it didn't use the environment against you. The only rumor that I've heard...
Well, we did try and talk to it first. Maybe it didn't. I don't know. Sorry, I interrupted you. Keep going.
The only rumor that I've heard when it comes to white dragons is that they can create a freezing fog out of thin air. Spreads, consumes everything in its path, and those that aren't hardy at nature will find themselves chilled to the bone. And if you find yourself stuck in the fog, supposedly you eventually will, well, be nothing more than a block of ice.
An Okahaw popsicle. Well, okay, I think I get the gist. Run away, only fight him outside the lair. Probably won't happen. Probably will have to face a few more.
Yeah, you
before
you,
I die.
You would be Otto. Like, this is all happening while you're basically out trying to sell your item.
Good to know.
Well, I think I've wasted enough of your time.
I'm always interested in talking with adventurers. You never know what they're up to these days.
Yeah, this is the whole thing with the cult and all the fucking bullshit we have going on. You know, the horn this morning. Gotta figure that out next. All that bullshit, you know how it is.
Remember hearing the horn. Well, if you're the ones that are taking a look into all that mess, and you're the ones...
Yep, that's us. Me and Malkar over there. Points to a random person in the tavern, who looks like he is asleep. Me and Malkar over there.
For now, my friends, I think it's best if you go catch up with your other friends, as he sort of places a hand on your shoulder and points over to where Malkar was sitting and makes it obvious to you Malkar is no longer there.
Wait, there's no one there. Oh, I get it now. Oh.
It's probably
I'm sorry.
Best if you catch up with your friends.
You know, I think I'd rather... I think that I should get some rest. Do you have a room?
Yeah, that we do. Top floor. Chucks you.
Yeah, I'll take one.
He chucks you a pair of keys.
Thanks, mate. I'm gonna stumble over to the stairs. Or what looks like stairs.
Falls in the well.
I'll go to one of the pillars and try to start climbing it.
Yeah, no, you would find a staircase. It's not displayed on this map.
Then I would go to the stairs.
Yeah. It's not displayed on
this map.
Go
up the stairs and then... Yeah, I'll just go to the room and pass out on the bed.
All right.
All four in the world.
I'm talking to here. Number 42, who I know for a fact is named Driz. He's a fucking badass.
Only if you were like a druid and you cast spider climb and you started climbing up the fucking wall.
Were you still looking at the handout, John?
Oh, there is a beholder and a fucking mind flayer.
Number 42 is Driz, like the only okay drow. He uses two magical swords and he's a fucking badass.
Well done, you actually found Driz.
There's a whole book series on his stuff.
Yeah, there's a. Every NPC on that handout is named.
I see number 10 is the Red Wizard. Or one of them.
Number 10?
Top floor.
Well, it's a wizard. It's not the Red Wizard you're aware of.
Ah.
That is Elminster.
Where's the map button?
80 is an intellect devourer. That poor sucker. About to be a puppet.
What are you looking for, Tyson?
I got it.
I'm still just laughing at Matt just sitting there, just reading.
I almost thought that was Keanu Reeves, just suddenly.
I only know that because Matt, like, tweeted that out, like, when it originally, dropped.
Yeah.
And then the dice around him.
Alright.
Alucard, would you like to talk to some Randa?
God, no.
The funny thing is I was not pushing for Tesla to talk to somebody.
Socializing fuck now.
So, with that said and done, you guys have the rest of the first week. We will start with you, Malkar, since you didn't do anything special. What would you like to do over the course of the first week?
Go for the things on my list.
Okay.
Oh, it's Minsk! Number 22!
Alright, so you are going to be trying to purchase some of the items on your list. So, finding magic items to purchase requires at least 1 work week of effort and 100 gold in expenses. Spending more time and money increases your chance of finding high-quality items. I will need a persuasion check to determine the quality of the seller found, and you will gain a +1 bonus on the check for the first work week that you spend, and beyond that first that is spent seeking a for every work week beyond the first that is spent seeking a seller, and you will also get a +1 bonus for every additional 100 gold spent on the search. So at first, it will be your persuasion check +2, and if you would like to invest more money, or if you would like to invest that second week, you can increase the number at the that minimum that you get.
With I'll just try baseline with the first week.
Baseline for the first week? Okay.
Would I see Malkar on the street? Would I just wave to him if he has to go out there to go searching for his shit?
Oh my fucking god. Alright, week 2.
So, 14.
Entire time.
Oh my goddamn 4.
So,
+8 though.
Can I get... Can I get a D4, please? Four. Okay, and then can I get 4 percentiles, please? So roll percentile 4 times. D100. To do that, right click on the D10 and hit percentile. Then just roll it once, then roll it again and again and again until you roll 4 times. So the first is 43.
How many times exactly?
4 in total. 58. 19. And 63. So, the person that you would have found selling magical equipment offers to you the list of wares that he has available currently. of those wares, he shows you a potion of frost giant strength, a potion of invulnerability, a spell scroll of fourth level. The spell is to be determined. A potion of mind reading. And seconds. A ring of force resistance. Would you be interested in buying any of those items?
Nope.
Okay. So you can subtract 100 gold. That's your first week.
I'll spend the next week looking for stuff.
Yep, we'll get to that in just a second. Ozen, you have your first week.
Alright. What is it now? Persuasion?
It is persuasion. 100 gold. You'll get a +2, and if you would like to spend more gold, you can increase it up to +12. You would need to spend 1,000 more gold.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, God. I feel bad.
Well, looks like we're spending 1,000 gold looking for someone better.
Also, on Dan, one quick question.
What's up?
Would a bag of holding be considered magical, or
it is
maybe
magical.
A little bit like not rare?
It is magical.
I'll need to find a shop for that, too.
Again, there's no shop. You're looking for individual buyers.
Oh, right, all right. Sorry. I forget.
Can I get a D6? Or, hold on, you rolled a 5? And then +2. Can I get a D4? Sorry.
No, I said I'm spending 1,000.
Oh, you are going to spend 1,000? Okay. So you're going to add 12 to that. So 17?
It would... Yeah. I realized that you are putting in the +2 along with it. Yeah, so 17.
Okay, can I still get a D4? Yeah.
How much do I need for a D6?
let me reveal, the D6 is the lowest possible magic item table. All of the others,
okay.
I need a D4. 2? All right. Okay, so can I get, let me see the table here. Can I get 2 percentiles? So 2 D100s.
Wait, what?
So right click.
Seven, you got 0. 7. Yeah. Fucking
hell. Oh, that was 7. Okay, that was.
7 that out was. Of 100. Hog. Won the game.
So you got a 7 and an 85?
Yeah.
Did he win the game, Clay?
We'll find out.
Waiting for that 1 or 100. That's the actual win.
The poor 2.
Fuck 2, man.
So,
2 will always be number 2.
What you would be offered here from the first vendor that you, or from the first seller that you come across, is 1 second. This seller has a potion of supreme healing a potion of vitality. And what appears to be studded leather armor of acid resistance.
Ooh.
Acid resistance. Is that plus one or no, no bonus?
No bonuses. It just gives you resistance to acid damage.
Ah, damn, it sucks.
Does Tiamat have... Are we gonna have to kill an acid dragon?
Well, a black dragon, maybe.
We killed the black acid? We dealt with black already.
Black's done. White's done. Fire, lightning...
Is green... I know there's a green head. Is green poison or acid? That's the question.
Green is poison. Green is poison. Okay, we were, green I is was poison. Talking, I was talking to the guy, and he was talking about the green dragon, which was poison.
Okay.
Actually, this dwarf killed the green dragon 15 years ago. Maybe adult.
It's not a dwarf, by the way. That's a human.
What? What say, kind of fucking voice was that for a human? It's Scottish.
One with an accent.
What? Probably.
It's fine. All right. What is a potion of vitality?
You know what? You did say human, didn't you?
Yeah, I said human from the very beginning, Mister. I don't pay attention.
Yeah.
You drink your real life too.
I would like to direct your attention
what
to
what does the
note.
Potion of vitality do?
The potion of vitality, whenever you would drink the potion, it will remove any exhaustion you are suffering, cure any disease or poison affecting you, and for the next 24 hours you regain the maximum number of hit points for any hit die you spend.
How much is it?
Was the hit point restoring one a potion of restoration?
Vitality.
No. I'm talking about.
He also had a superior one.
Did he?
No. I'm talking about like max hit point. Like when you get fucking drained by a vampire, there's a potion that gives you hit points back. It was like what restoration or something. Very
rare. It would be whatever. Like would probably give you the benefits of a rest.
Something like that. Yeah.
Tyson, can you give me 1d4 plus 1?
2 gold.
Two.
There you go.
So it's 2?
2,000 gold.
It would be... It is halved for consumables. So... $7,500 gold.
Jesus Christ.
Magic items aren't cheap. Magic items aren't cheap.
Even consumable ones? That's a bit much.
That's half the price.
Okay, I just fucking make one. Shit, fuck it.
Yeah, fuck that, dude. Fuck that noise.
To the grave area, just start collecting herbs there.
He got 6,000 gold for his dagger of venom, and a potion cost 7,500. I think or 15,000. I think those numbers are a bit off. I'm not blaming you, Clay. I'm saying whoever made that table is an idiot.
Yeah, you can take that up with the guys that made D&D. Then.
All right, what's their email?
You can go find them on Twitter. That's a whole lot easier.
All right, let me look at Twitter.
And he only got that much for his dagger because he rolled so high on his persuasion that the person offered him 150% base value.
Fuck. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No, that's those numbers.
I told you persuasion is my specialty.
Well, no. I'm saying, man, why the fuck is a potion that is consumed after one use cost 15,000 when a dagger, sure, it's a shit dagger, but it's a dagger nonetheless. A magical weapon is only 6,000. I don't know. I don't get it.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, the prices could be a lot higher as well.
Yeah, that's insane. That's insane.
Yeah, that's fucking worthless to
economy.
Me. Economy. Like, why would I pay that much for that? Like,
oh, yeah, no. No, I'm fully aware that you guys are going to hate me for the prices here, but...
No, we're not hating you.
I'm doing it by the book when it comes to the prices on this, because magic items are supposed to be rare.
Yeah, yeah. I get that much. It's just, I don't... And I'm not, again, it's not against you. It's the, whoever made the system is an idiot.
Okay, well,
do
me a solid, and we can bitch about it after the session. No more bitching about prices during the session, because we're already 2 hours in, and we're still doing shopping.
I mean, we did RP. That's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Either way, no more bitching during the session from this point forward, please. Do it after.
I mean, like, that... That's it. Like, I don't care at this point.
Right. So that's the end of your first week. Oak.
I'm going to look for the belt.
Okay. So you're going to try to look specifically for the
belt. Mainly, yeah. Specifically for the belt. And if I come across anything, protection, like rings, cloaks, I'll buy them. Probably. Okay. Unless they're stupid.
So, remember.
Can I, can I ask?
Go ahead.
Can I ask Otto to roll this for me?
Yeah, you could...
Bad at persuasion?
Yeah, you could get together with Otto, and you could essentially work with him to hunt down what it is that you're looking
for. Could
you help brother
out? Sure. Not really great at this, you know. And you can...
that's fine, yeah.
So, 28.
Yeah. Is it 20? Why is it 28?
Plus two, because you gotta spend 100. You gotta spend 100 gold just looking for a seller.
Can I make it 30? Because that sounds like a fun number. How much do I pay for 30?
So it's 28 right now. You'd have to pay another 200 gold.
Sure, that sounds fun. Let's do that.
Okay, so you're gonna go for 30.
Yeah.
Okay,
I subtracted the gold.
Can you give me 1d4?
Okay. I was doing slash R. Here we go.
3. Right? Yes. And then this table over here. Can I go ahead and get you to give me 3 D100s? So percentile.
Okay.
So I'm curious, how do we even D100s work, like, if you're playing, like, at a table? How does it even work?
It's you roll one specific dice, which has two digits, and then just a normal D10, and you combine the two.
Yeah. 86, 90, and 11. Whoo, boy.
Are those good? Are those good, Clay?
Maybe.
Good?
Maybe a little bag of holding I can buy for myself.
We'll find out.
What?
So.
Question mark? Hopefully I have the money for this.
Just me the goat. Jesus Christ.
Got a problem with my music, boy?
Nah, it just feelsy. We're shopping. Very off-putting. But it's fine.
Oh, that's weird. If you look at the top left, Tyson and John are AFK, I think. Then so they have like ZZZs. You see that? Or like just idling. Well, that's interesting.
If you're not clicking around, like in the thing, just weird like that. It does it when you're typing too, as a little bubble.
Shiranakatta.
Alright. Can I get you to give me another D4?
Okay. 4.
4. Okay. The merchant that you have come across at the end of the week, the first week.
Yeah.
reveals his wares, and what you see is wow, that's actually kind of fitting for Tyler.
That's not good.
An instrument of the bards.
I'll take that.
Yeah, I don't care.
From Lucan Bandor.
A what?
Lucan Bandor. It's like a... I'm trying to remember what it would be close to.
It is...
not a sitar, but like...
no idea.
This particular instrument of the bards can only be attuned to by bards. And
I mean, okay, hold on. I'll show Tyler to this guy.
Yeah. Well, that's the first item.
Yeah. Yeah. So he can buy that if he wants to.
Yeah.
I won't.
Oh,
that weird words you said that I didn't understand at all. Was that the name of the instrument?
Yeah, it's not the name of the instrument itself. It's the
It's
a name tied to the instrument. Anyway,
okay. I thought that was a second item. Like, what the fuck is that?
No.
Go ahead.
That particular instrument, Otto, has the following spells that you can cast from it. Fly, invisibility, levitate, protection from evil and good, entangle, fairy fire, shillelagh, and speak with animals.
Yo.
I'll take it.
Ask for the price first, buddy.
You can use an action to play the instrument and cast one of its spells. Once the instrument has been used to cast a spell, it can't be used to cast that spell again until the next dawn. The spell uses your spellcasting ability and spell save DC. So you essentially get one free cast of fly, invisibility, levitate, protection from evil and good, entangle, fairy fire, shillelagh,
holy
and speak
shit
with animals per day.
That's fucking lit.
But yeah, I have 13,181 gold. I'm fine.
How much is it, Clay?
You want to buy it, you said?
Yeah, I'll buy it.
Tyler, the potion was 15k. I wouldn't get so cocky.
Let me see here.
Wait, we still haven't sold all the stuff,
we did.
Arcadius has.
We did.
Yeah, you did.
I did?
Yes.
All the money that you're gonna have is on you.
Okay, Tyler, can I get 2d10?
Sure. Percentile or just normal d10?
Just normal d10.
Okay. 1 and 2.
So 13. And then can I also get a d12?
Sure.
Okay. This particular item, the seller is willing to part with it for 1,700 gold.
Okay.
And don't worry about the D12. That'll come in play later. Now, Oak, my friend.
Yeah.
The next thing that he had for you.
Yeah.
Was a periapt of wound closure.
The periapt? What is a periapt?
It's a necklace.
It is a pendant. While you
say
wear
necklace.
This, While you wear this pendant, you stabilize whenever you are dying at the start of your turn. In addition, whenever you roll a hit die to regain hit points, double the number of hit points it restores.
Oh! How much is it?
Can I get you to give me 2d10?
How much is it, love? Yeah, okay. It's been saying love all day today. It's 11. 11?
He would be willing to part with it for 1100 gold.
Okay. I want to hear the last item before I buy it. I'll keep it in mind, though.
The next item...
Belt! Please! Ruth cry?
Nah, re-snap. Your dreams are dead.
Damn. We'll see.
But please notice how I said next item.
Yeah. I don't know what that means, but okay.
I didn't say last.
Oh. 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 Uh-huh. Oh.
The next item is a very simplistic +2 rapier.
Ozen, you want this?
You mean Otto?
Tyson.
Ozen isn't there.
He had to say.
I will stop. Run to Ozen. Pick him up and bring him. Ozen, do you want a +2 rapier?
Why the fuck did you pick me up and drag me here?
Because I thought it would be funny. Do you want a +2 rapier?
No.
Oh, okay. Go back. Put him back where he was, and then come back.
So, how's your day going?
Right,
good sales?
Don't really need it. I don't know if this guy does. Points to Tyler, who is still there for some reason. Even after 30 minutes or so that he took bringing Ozen here and taking him back.
I've been talking with him.
The last item
on
the list that he has is a belt.
Oh! This is a bait.
Do you really think it's a bait?
If I say yes, you're gonna make it a bait. So no. What is it? Just say it. God damn it.
It's gonna be the games. You go. Only 6,000 gold.
As he pulls it out, you see...
Oak's eyes go wide.
Yeah, as he pulls it out, you see in very intricate detail the designs of frost giants.
Ah, fuck! God damn it!
The music would have been so fitting if it was the right bells. But no.
Do you have a better one? Budgets? A not frost giant one.
Unfortunately, no, but I mean, this belt already sets your strength.
You know who does?
This belt already sets your strength to 23. I mean, nigga, you only got 18.
What? What? 23? I thought frost giant was like 18.
No.
Wait a second.
You got your belts all messed up.
Oh!
Frost giant is very rare. And
I'll take it.
Will change your strength score to 23.
Papa Clay, I'm sorry. I didn't read good.
With that in mind, can I get 1d4 +1, please?
Okay, 5.
5. Yikes.
5,000.
How much did you say?
Maybe. Nothing, sorry, go ahead.
How much did you say?
I didn't say anything.
Because you rolled maximum value. He wants full retail price of 50,000 gold.
15,000?
50,000.
Yeah, I don't got that. So drop your price or you don't have a sale. I actually don't have that, so.
Yeah.
He needs to drop his price.
You can personally give me a persuasion check.
Okay. I will use my inspiration.
Okay.
Thank God I did.
Dropped a 1 for a 19, 24.
So, okay. I'll tell him the number I have. I'll tell him I have 9,000 plus 2,500. That's
so. Here's what I want you to do.
I have like. Yeah, go ahead.
Give me a D4.
Yeah. What about it?
You just keep rolling max on that 4, don't you?
Why is it a D4? Re? 25% chance!
20,000.
Can I roll another one?
Halved.
Nah, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Okay, look. You're a good kid, and I know what you're trying to do for the world. The cheapest I can go is 10,000.
Deal. I give him 10,000, which is all my money.
Don't worry, I'll help you.
Oh, you want to pay? Is that right, motherfucker?
No, I meant for other items.
You
still need to pay, by the way.
I'll pay him what I have. I think I have 10,000. I definitely have 10,000.
You most definitely have over 10,000.
Yeah. So,
because it's 10 gold per platinum.
Can I convert this shit?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Okay.
All of you can convert your currency if you would like.
Oh god, we pull the calculator. One second.
Just in gold and platinum alone, that's 9,300 Tesla.
Yeah, I mainly want to do the other shit first, because I don't want to be carrying 139,488 copper.
Yeah, feel free.
I have 138,000 copper.
You can feel free to subtract 10,000 gold in some manner or fashion. And
okay,
here is your newfound belt of giant strength, my friend.
Yay! Did I? Fuck, dude. I seriously got that wrong? What was the shitty one? Was it Hill Giant or something?
Hill Giant is the lowest one.
Ah, fuck me. I even wrote that to you, didn't I?
Yep.
You, God damn
literally,
it.
Your exact word was any higher than Frost,
yeah,
please.
Anything higher than Frost,
I'm like,
yeah.
And I'm like, this man really trying to go for a legendary, yeah, belt, huh?
No.
This man dumbass, really all. Trying to go for that legendary belt.
Nope, I'm just stupid.
No, it's okay.
Listen, I don't need you to tell me it's okay, alright, motherfucker?
Going to anyways.
Okay. So that's 3,000 right there.
Question on for silver pieces it's every 100 silver equals 1 gold.
No. Silver to gold is 10 to 1.
Oh, 10 to 1.
Copper to gold is 100 to 1.
Oh, I have mixed up my ratios then.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Platinum must be...
Platinum is 1 platinum is 10 gold. Silver is 10 silver is 1 gold. Copper is 100 copper is 1 gold.
Okay. Sorry about that.
So turns out I can still afford the amulet. So I want to buy that too.
Okay, you also wanted to buy the amulet?
Yeah, I have enough gold, so I'll buy it at market price. Or, I'm not in a position to haggle after.
Okay.
So, if it's the same guy, that is.
Yeah, it's the same guy. So 1,100 gold for that.
No position. Yep.
Maybe it was. Sure thing.
Okay, I'm out of money. Yay.
This is what the necklace looks like, by the way.
Oh, cool. It's even got hands. Okay. Both are attuned, right?
Both are attunement, yes.
Okay. Pretty sure I can.
You can,
I
believe.
Sword. The sword's also attuned, right?
You have the sword, and now both of these. So
plate isn't.
You've hit your three attunements.
Oh, I can. Oh, fuck, I forgot. I had this arrow catching shield. God damn it. That's
you,
okay.
You can try to sell,
I'll sell that next week, yeah.
Yeah, you can try to sell that next week. Alright.
I'll loot myself right now.
Is there a point in carrying cop platinum? Should I just turn it into gold?
That's up to you.
I should, right?
I personally just turned it into gold, trying to do half my silver into gold, too.
Yeah, that's up
to you.
Yeah,
I will.
Alright, so.
Okay.
That takes care of week one. Now we'll speed through week two. I'm going to go in order of the top left-hand corner. So, Tyson, week two. What would you like to do, my friend? Remember, you can get together
Tyler
with either... I gotta say, you can either get together with Otto or Malkar or anyone, really.
I'd go with you, sure. Do you want me to roll for you in this situation?
Yes, roll for me. roll the shoot. Jesus fuck.
Five again?
18.
I mean, you could try rolling, see if it's harder than mine.
I don't care. I don't care.
So it's an 18. Would you like to spend any more gold to increase the number?
No.
No?
I'll spend some gold for you. I'll put 200 gold
no,
in.
No, I don't want you to.
You don't want me to? Sure.
No. Okay. I don't want you to.
Okay.
Tyson's okay. Just fucking done.
You
know, he's done with light.
Give me a D4, Tyson. 4. Alright. So that is this table. Okay. Can I get 4% sets of percentiles? So 4 D100s. Fifty-seven, 17, 16, and 20. Yikes. Tables. So what he has available this week for you, Tyson, is 2 potions of supreme healing.
Jesus fuck!
a spell scroll of etherealness.
Do you want me to just grab a gun over here? Just 1 second.
A portable hole.
Ooh.
Oh, those okay. Are fun.
Valentin is at least interesting.
Hey, don't stick your dick
and
in
some
there,
plus
okay?
2 studded leather.
And some plus 2 studded leather. Okay.
It went up!
How much did the plus 2 studded leather be?
How much is the plus 2 studded leather? Jesus, fuck. Two potions of superior healing and a potion of etherealness. I mean, a scroll of ethereal. I have 2 oils of etherealness.
I feel like Ogma's just looking down at you right now, like, oh, okay. You want your items? Nah.
Tyson, can yes. I get you to give me 1d4? Did you? God damn it! Why do y'all keep rolling, Max? Would you like to give me a persuasion check?
Listen, nigga, I had a long day. I have killed many things, and I am keeping this world alive.
Would you like to give me persuasion with advantage? 18.
With advantage.
And 20, hey.
And a 20.
Wait,
natural
20. Did no one see that? It's fine. Don't worry about it.
It's like your 3 just turned into a 19 somehow.
I'm fucking dying over here.
Would you like to give me another d4?
Okay.
There we go.
Yeah, I'm just laughing in your face right now, saying "fuck you."
It's those fucking potions got me.
He would be willing to part with the studded leather for 6,000 gold.
Fucking Christ!
Okay,
I guess that is worth it.
Sure, like Jesus, fuck. I
How was that potion 15,000? It doesn't make sense.
You know what? For reference, can I get a reference on the spell scroll of etherealness?
A price on the spell scroll?
Yeah.
Sure thing, buddy. Can you give me 1d4 plus 1?
25,000.
Is it just not rolling?
So 3. Okay, there you go. So, and then half that, 15,000 gold.
What? How?
Which is
Who
funny.
Fucking made this?
Which is funny because the Scroll of Etherealness actually has a legitimate cost tied to it in Fantasy Grounds. You would actually make a profit if you bought it and then resold it because its cost is set at 16,169.
Oh God!
Can I just show him the two more? I'm just gonna take out one of the oars and be like, "You fucking scam artist."
You go to jail.
I don't care. I don't care. I'm just going. I got my fucking studded leather.
I bet the guy who made this system was bullied in school.
I bet he fucking was.
Keep it now. Fucking keep in mind if I didn't give Tyson the persuasion check there and re-rolling the price, that studded leather would have cost 50,000 gold. Just the same way your belt of giant strength started out at 50,000.
50?
Yes, 50.
This guy is definitely a escape artist. Get the fuck out of here. Tyson, take a breath.
You know what? From what I learned, I need to sell this potion of gaseous form, this oil, and these oil of etherealness, and we'll be 50, fucking 000. Rich. That is what I figured. That is what I've learned.
Can we go back to the town of many sun theories?
Wait, have we sold? We sold the dragon stuff already, right? The dragon parts? Or...
Yes, okay. We sold everything. Everything has been sold.
Okay, sorry. I keep getting confused.
It's all gone.
It's all gone.
If you just look in the party sheet up in the all top right corner, I with the 3 people. Now, that tells you what we have.
With that said and done, that wraps up the second week for Ozen. Otto, your second week begins. You sold the first week. Would you like to try and attempt to buy this week?
I guess I would. I'd be looking for 2 things. First would be diamond dust.
Okay.
Looking for that, and then probably the studded leather if I can find it.
Okay.
If it's in reason.
All right, so you can give me a persuasion check. You'll get plus 2 if you would like to increase that further. It can be 100 gold per, and for 1,000 gold will give you plus 10. So right now you're at 19. If you would like to invest another 1,000 gold, you could go up to 29.
I will bring it up to 29.
Okay. Go ahead and give me 1d4, please. I'll tell you what, we'll go with this table here. Can I get that d4, Tyler?
Sorry, I was putting in my mount. My bad.
Go ahead and give me 4 D100s, 4 percentiles.
Sure.
This could get very interesting very quickly.
Uh-oh.
2.
2?! World's ending! We've gotten a 7 and a 2!
This could get very interesting very quickly. Can I get another? We need 4 sets in total.
Sorry.
91. 77 and 90. Okay.
That's too many.
Oh, I did one too many. My bad.
Yeah. Skip the 47. All right, yeah, so. What this merchant has available for you, my friend, is a +2 rapier.
Is that the same rapier?
No, this one has some fancier emblems on it.
Ah.
Oh.
There's fancier teeth that it's picked.
Okay.
It's Sherlock's rapier. Just randomly picked it up.
A vicious great axe.
Oh. Nah, I have Hazarim. I'm fine.
I was gonna say, I can't even pick that up. I'm weak.
What weapon will you ever need again, Tess?
I know, right? I was like...
77?
Huh? 77? That's how much damage it does? No. I'll take it.
No, he's reading a number.
Yeah, I know.
Holy fucking shit.
Oh? Uh-oh. When the DM says that.
Tyler.
Motherfucker, run.
Get you rid of the bards again?
No, my friend. Before you, the merchant brings out a sword.
Simply?
And you see him begin to unwrap it. And what he has before you is a sunblade.
Air Industries! Jesus.
Can I roll for advantage? Just, I know the price is going to be insanely high.
Whew. Let's see. Pretty sure sunblade is legendary.
Yeah, so it's like 50,000. Like,
oh no, Sunblade is Sunblade is rare.
There's no, there's no way it's legendary because we've seen like fucking 4 of them.
Yeah, that's what you think. Can I get 2d10, please?
What did I think?
Yep.
And your last roll was a 90. I'll keep that in mind. 2d10 for 4.
That feels bad.
He will be willing to part with the Sunblade for 4,000 gold.
There you go.
Okay, I'll take it.
You are now the proud owner of a Sunblade.
Oh, so he didn't even, like, bring out a sword. He just brought out the hilt. Oh, that's cool. It's like a fucking lightsaber. Does it make the sound? You know?
Still 8,000 gold left.
Nice. It's a good pickup.
It is indeed. Now I just need my diamond dust and my bag of holding, and I'll be good.
Yeah. The next thing that he has on his list might be better if I show you this. I think I have artwork.
Oh.
The next thing that he pulls out is a rod of tentacles.
Ooh.
Kinky.
I know a character. Wait a second. This is
can this be used as a weapon?
Okay. Quick, real quick story time, I have to say. You know how Goto died to the rope or whatever it was called? Mm-hmm. As a gag, I made Oak's temptation, the rod of, like tentacles, getting gripped by tentacles, as a gag joke.
Oh god.
Just saying. And now when he got gripped by the plant monster.
Now I remember why you were having such a good time when Tyson was using you to check the windows.
Yeah, I was like,
it all makes sense now, yeah, Tyson.
It's been the meme all along. And people say I'm not good at role playing. Actually, no one says that. Anyone who would say that kicked their ass.
Tesla.
I mean, you're not. So.
What's up?
Not Tesla, sorry. Tyler.
Okay.
This rod, made by the Drow, is a magic weapon that ends in three rubbery tentacles. While holding the rod, you can use an action to direct each tentacle to attack a creature you can see within 15 feet of you. Each tentacle makes a melee attack roll with a +9 bonus. On a hit, the tentacle deals 1d6 bludgeoning damage, and if you hit a target with all three tentacles, it must make a DC 15 constitution saving throw. On a failure, the creature's speed is halved, it has disadvantage on dexterity saving throws, and can't use reactions for 1 minute.
Yo, that last part.
Moreover, on each of its turns, it can take either an action or a bonus action, but not both. At the end of each of its turns, it can repeat the saving throw, ending the effect on itself on a success.
Yo. Say it again. Yo. Yo.
As far as the price, can I get you to give me 2d10, please?
Ouch.
8,000 gold.
Yeah, no thanks on that one.
Okay. And the last item that he has on his list.
Oh.
Manka Pog?
It's a bag of holding with diamond, four things diamond dust in it.
No, that tend to be good. Diamond
dust isn't rare. Or hard.
No, I know it's not. I need it though. Glyph of warning.
You can go to a general store and find it. Don't worry about that, buddy.
That's what I was trying to do, but I thought it was magic, so.
No, it's
not diamond dust.
No.
Oh, wow. Let me double check and see if I have a table for this. Can I get you to give me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Can I get you to give me a D12?
Sure.
2. The next thing that he pulls out is a small cylinder-like red stone. In fact, it's the one you can see here in this picture.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. If John's saying, oh, shit, that must be really good. Wait a second.
What's the fucking name?
This, my friends, is the Ion Stone of Agility. Once activated, it will hover around your head, and while it is there, you will be more nimble, yes?
Oh, shit.
I see.
Essentially, once attuned to it, it will give you a flat dexterity score increase by 2. It does not, however, increase your maximum. So in your case, you would go from 16 to 18.
Interesting.
That's not too shabby, though.
It's probably expensive as shit.
Well, it doesn't increase maximum, so it can't be that expensive.
See that.
Can I get you to give me a D4 plus 1?
I say about this stupid system, which fucking has potions at 15k!
Don't worry, you rolled a 7-11 one. For 50,000. Yep.
Yeah, this is a very rare wondrous item. He would be willing to give it to you for 20,000 gold. Its normal market price is around 50,000.
Yeah, no thanks.
Okay.
Damn. Well, hey, Tyson, what's your dex at? 20. Are you 20 down?
Okay. Yeah, I thought he was max.
Okay. Oh, so there's no one who would benefit.
That brings us to your second week.
Oh, okay. Well, for my second week, I want to try and sell the arrow catching shield, but I would also like to meet with Ondar.
Okay.
Can I give him my shit to sell as well?
You can only sell.
Well, Amorev, I'm gonna ask Otto.
You can only sell one item at a time.
Okay.
I'll ask Otto. Because
the way selling works. Bye. The way selling works, Tyson, is essentially you can find a buyer for one magic item by spending one work week and 25 gold. Which is used to spread word of the desired sale. A character must pick one item at a time to sell. The gold itself is for the advertisement. At the same time, whenever you're buying, and I tell you, you know, it's 100 gold while you're buying, that is basically to ensure a luxurious lifestyle for that week because it's to attract buyers. So for these 2 weeks, you guys are living a very luxurious lifestyle.
Oh.
I can sell them for you, if you'd like, depending on what you need to sell. So, would you just leave us with 2 days?
I don't know how. Like, plus one in shit, like, plus one leather, or plus one longsword.
I just push my push it up.
I feel like you could sell, like a general sword. I think you could, but I don't know. Maybe like a blacksmith. We're gonna seek him out.
Do it on your own time.
You are trying to sell the arrow catching shield?
Yeah.
Okay.
That'll be repeat.
So that is rare.
So. Can I make him roll it for me, or no? Should I roll it?
I mean, if Malkar or Otto wants to be the one spreading the word of the sale for you, then they can be the one to roll it.
I mean,
Malkar scares me, so I'll go to Otto.
He scares you?
It's a little bit.
He's scary with the mask, man.
17.
Probably higher than I would have rolled. I'll increase it to 20 for the memes.
Well, you don't invest more money in this case.
Oh, you don't increase it.
Yeah.
Okay.
In this case, you
gotcha.
Don't increase. So you got the 17. You would find a buyer for the arrow catching shield. They would offer
you. Want this.
They would offer you 4,000 gold.
4K, huh? You sure? I'll sell it to him. Okay. And then I want to meet with Ondar.
Okay. I don't know if you already have in mind what you want to talk to Ondar about. But...
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I do.
All right. Go ahead and start that off then.
Hey. How do I? Am I like running into him or?
Yeah.
Do I,
no.
Like,
you.
Go to
you.
His
no.
Office,
you. Like
or...
you would find him, most likely around the Lord's Palace still. he would be in that area.
Okay, okay. Hey, Anta! Anta!
Ok, what do you need now, boy?
Well, wanted to catch up, but first, here. I'm gonna hand him a bag of 1,290 gold.
He takes the bag and hefts it up a little bit.
That's for earlier, when we, like a year ago, I guess now, when you lent me some money. I sat back.
Alright, I do remember actually investing some money for the equipment and things of that nature for you and your group at the time.
There's that back.
Are you sure you couldn't make more use of this? Believe me, the money that we invested is well worth it.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't take it. I won't be able to fight knowing that I've taken when I don't need it. And I don't need it.
I can respect that. He clasps a hand on your shoulder for a second. In that case, then, let me, in turn, and he lets go of your shoulder, he grabs your arm, opens your hand, and he places the bag back in your hands. In that case,
but
let me pay you for the work that you still have to do.
On thaw.
Trust me, boy. We knew the amount of money that we were investing, and we would have invested much more if we needed to. Do not worry. The fact that you are willing to return it proves your character more than enough for me.
When this is all over, you're taking that back. I don't care if you're paying me or not. I'll keep it till the end. After, I can't take it from you.
I'll settle for a long night in the Yawning Portal when it's said and done. On you.
Alright. Why not? It'll be a long one. 1,000 gold worth.
Oh, that it will. But, it's been 2 weeks now. Shouldn't you be on your way, my friend?
Yes, well, I think we're about to leave, truth be told. I don't know if we're going north or south, or no other north, but we'll see.
Well, if you want my honest opinion, go south. Seek out the worm speakers first. They're a bigger threat than what lies to the north.
I'll take it to heart.
Now, run along. I have more business to attend to, unfortunately. They have me up to my fucking elbows in paperwork here.
Never understood why you chose the paperwork life. I don't think I ever will.
Trust me, boy. I didn't choose it. It chose me. I'd much rather be out there killing something.
I'll see you around, Anta.
Be safe.
I'm walking off.
Alright. With that said and done, the last member of the party, Malkar, what would you like to do? For your final week.
Attempt number two.
Attempt number two?
I'm shopping.
Alright.
Watch out, they like to sell potions!
I know this. Not just any potions.
Hey, look on the bright side, though. You can probably make a fuck ton of money making and selling potions.
Oh. You have no idea how hard it was for me to prevent Ozen from going to fucking Eru and just being a fucking potion seller to fund his fucking research for the rest of the campaign. He needs to just sell, like, one potion a year.
Alright, Malkar, are you gonna roll for yourself or are you gonna get help?
I'm gonna roll for myself.
Alright, I like it.
Alright, I'm back.
This hell begin.
Welcome back. So.
Did I miss any good items?
Nah. Alright, Malkar. So you are buying. So it is 100 gold up front. You can give me a persuasion check. Plus 2. And then if you would like, on that 24, you can increase it up to another plus 10, depending on the amount of gold that you want to invest, if you want to invest any.
Nope.
All right, so you're just going to leave it at 24?
Uh-huh.
All right, give me a d4. Two. Okay. Can I get 2 D100s? This could get pretty interesting. 61 and a 26. Okay, this got rather interesting.
Uh-oh.
I went with him just in case.
Would you like the 61 just... or the 26 first?
26, let's see.
26? You watch as the person that you have managed to set up a meeting with begins to pull out what appears to be a robe.
Uh-huh.
And as he pulls the covering off of it, you see a robe that mimics the cosmos itself.
Fuck, I know this is really good. Everybody
does. Is this that cloak from Harry Potter?
I'm just kidding, sorry.
This black robe is embroidered with small silver stars. You gain a plus one bonus to all saving throws while you wear it. 6 stars located on the robe's upper front portion are particularly large. While wearing this robe, you can use an action to pull off one of the stars and use it to cast Magic Missile as a 5th level spell. Daily at dusk, 1d6 removed stars reappear on the robe.
Be the pepper.
What the fuck?
Feel the pepper.
While you wear the robe, you can use an action to enter the astral plane along with everything you are wearing and carrying, and you remain there until you use an action to return to the plane you were on.
Malachar is a fucking Sith Lord, Jesus.
As far as its price, could you give me 1d4 plus 1?
55,000.
Oh! Daddy, yes!
Ow.
He would be willing to part with it initially for 20,000.
Oh, God.
If you're actually interested in it, you can try to talk him down.
Let's see what the other item is first.
Okay.
John, I got cash.
The other item...
I got you, fam. 6K. Willing to give.
Are you, though?
Well, yeah, handy against face
rather, the next item that he has, I should say. Because he has a few, still.
He has, like, 94.
Oh.
87.
You watch as he pulls out an old dusty tome.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
It's the Necronomicon. No.
Fucking conquer the world with that thing.
Can I get you to give me a D4, John?
Uh-oh.
as he sets the tome down in front of you, Malkar, what you see is a very ancient book. Should you spend 48 hours over a period of 6 days or fewer studying this book's contents and practicing its guidelines, your wisdom score will increase by 2, as will your maximum for that score.
Pog.
Not that useful for me, sadly.
That would be useful for probably Tyson. No? Tyson. Are you wisdom?
I scale it.
He scales it.
None of us scale wisdom?
Not a single person scales
like
wisdom.
A druid.
God damn it.
We aren't druids. We don't need to be...
How much is it? How much is it? Let's get to that part.
D4 plus 1, please.
I think he already rolled it.
He rolled a 4 to determine which tome it was.
Ah.
Oh.
Oof. Can he re-roll that?
20,000 gold.
The book? No.
Yeah. The next item that he has. You watch as he you watch as he reaches into his pouch, and after a few moments you watch as he pulls out a small ring. The ring is unlike any you have seen before.
Hey, can you spot that for me?
Just kidding, you need that more than me.
No.
The ring...
I could put a fucking fireball on this thing.
...will store any spells cast into it, holding them until the attuned wearer uses them. And it can store up to 5 levels worth of spells at a time.
Oh my god, we could store it with healing spells.
Oh! You don't have healing spells, do you? It's okay. Me and the other one do. I got you, fam.
But as long as I'm attuned to it, you can cast the spell.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I got you, fam.
Alright, what do I need to roll to determine price? If that's the thing.
Its price is 6,000 gold.
Ooh, that's way affordable for me.
Yo, I got that cash too. I'll fund you. I'll fund you with the spells and the cash.
Come on, don't become poor now.
Hey, that's man. Okay. I don't need money.
Having,
I'm a paladin.
Having spell heals just ready whenever is fucking great.
Yeah. Especially when our dumbass paladin uses all his goddamn spells on smite, nice. Fucking idiot.
You know, it's just you, so.
Huh?
What are you talking about? What are
you on about?
Well, yeah. Anyways, I'll stop interrupting. Clay!
So would you like to buy it?
It said next item. Let's see what's
I'm gonna say there is one last item. The last item that he has is probably the most interesting to me. The last item, something that I don't think was on anyone's lists, but is nonetheless very unique, I'll call it. Where was the roll again? Because I've been rolling myself on top of what you guys roll, so you're not getting all of your rolls yourself. I'm giving you a set number of rolls, and then I determine the rest of their inventory. There it is. You're probably going to shit yourself, John.
Alright.
In the process of writing, actually.
Here it is, I think. Yep, there it is. It's very interesting. Unfortunately, I don't think any of you can afford it. Not even if you pulled together all of your money.
Yeah, probably not.
You watch as he pulls out a tiny black pebble. About 2 foot diameter in size.
The pebble of Nuke. It exists. Wait a second! Is this clay? Is this? Oh my god.
As he lets go of the pebble directly in front of you, Malkar, you watch as it just hovers in the air.
This is not... Wait a second. What was it called? The Great Pebble of Boar Slaying?
No,
is this not the...
Tyson still has that.
Okay. About to fucking... I blew my load of... God damn it. Whatever, this is boring now. I'm out.
This, my friend, is... I believe in this land it's known as the Sphere of Annihilation.
Oh, okay.
What?
Yeah, that's the thing. Legendary.
What?
This tiny little sphere will obliterate all matter it passes through and all matter that passes through it. Very dangerous.
Disintegration soon? I don't know. No, that wouldn't make sense.
I pick up a pebble. Can I toss it at it? Let's see.
Be my guest.
Toss the pebble into the sphere.
Yeah, as the pebble like hits the sphere, you watch as it just disappears. The pebble's nowhere to be seen.
Wait, what would happen if we threw that at Tiamat? I wonder.
Oh.
That'd be strong.
You take the thing. Shove it inside of Tiamat. Easy clap.
I said you could throw it, I think. Or something like that.
And how much is this interesting little object?
It's quite expensive. But I tell you what, for you, my friends, I give you special deal. 50,000 gold.
think I can afford that.
Should we go to the guild? Wait, let's go to the council. Get 50k as a loan so we can go kill Tiamat with the Pebble of Annihilation.
Just demand him to give it to us. We're sheriffs now. Hand it over. Just kidding. We'd probably get in trouble for that.
It would be very handy in our mission.
Yes, which is why I brought it.
Even we can't afford it.
Unfortunately, I do have to be able to make my money back.
See if he can borrow it.
The world is destroyed. How about
we'll bring it back, lol.
We'll give it back once we've completed the mission.
And what if we die? Oh wait, I'm not gonna say anything.
We're not there.
You seem like a relatively trustworthy guy, but this is still a lot of money.
Indeed it is. Not much money that many people...
Set up a payment plan!
It's on your credit card, you paid off over your time.
I tell you what, I can't give you the sphere, but maybe I have something else that might be useful for you.
Any swords? Rare ones.
Sunblades.
Maybe some of a lightning bolt variety?
Harry. For a shout.
Sword of Catching Thunder. You get struck like lightning the moment you touch it. No benefits.
You
just get struck by lightning. Nope. You just get struck by lightning. That's it. Nothing else.
I don't have any swords, unfortunately, but I do have something that I think would be perfect for you, my friend.
Oh?
It's pretty enough, the bag.
You watch as he pulls out a small wand and sort of laying it flat on both of his hands, he sort of extends it towards you. This, my friend, is, I believe the person I acquired it from said it was a, war mage's wand?
What does it do?
Well, from what he told me, it will increase the potency of your spell attacks. And, makes it a lot harder for things to hide from you when shooting at them from afar.
So you got Spell Sniper and,
But I have Spell Sniper. I only need more half cover. Does that mean they can't hide from me at all?
So what this is a Wand of the War Mage plus 3. While holding this wand, you would get a plus 3 bonus to all spell attack rolls determined by the wand's rarity. So you get the plus 3 bonus to all spell attacks. And in addition, you ignore half cover when making spell attacks.
What is its price?
He's only showing such spells.
I tell you what. Given what you're trying to do for the entire world itself, I'll bite the bullet on its price. I'll give it to you for the same price that I bought it for. 5,000 gold.
I'll take it in the Ring of Spell Storing. I don't suppose you can go any lower on the spell, the ring. I seem to be in need of a horse nowadays.
Did we look at the price on the robe, or did you ever get the price?
It was 20k.
Yeah, it was 20k.
Oh, was it 20k?
Yeah.
I thought it was more.
I couldn't afford that robe.
The ring was 6K originally.
Yeah.
Tell you what, 10,000, you can have them both.
It's a deal.
Wonderful doing business with you, my friend.
And it was wonderful doing business with you as well. If we're ever here again, I'll make sure to find you again.
Absolutely, my friend. Always be here within Waterdeep. We'll get to the Ring of Spell storing in just a little bit, by the way. Because we're not done with that.
Oh.
It already had spells to begin with! Nah, I don't know.
You're actually correct.
I know I am. My intuition skills are actually very good. No, no. Up to level 5. Come on now. Let's not get crazy.
Spell. Come on.
Let's not get crazy here.
Play. It's a wish spell. I don't think that you ever gave me my plus 2 armor.
That it defies all reality. And everything that it does and is.
Hey, what, you say
TMI? Thanks. I'm gonna get the wish spell so I can wish that there's a wish spell on my spell storing ring. Epica.
There is your plus 2 studded leather.
All right, thanks.
Now, let me see if this actually works the way it's supposed to.
I'll attune to the one that the war made, but the ring we're gonna have to have on someone else.
Are you at 3 attuned already?
What was my other thing? The staff, that did require...
You have the mask, yeah. Too. Staff, yeah. Mask.
A mask and the staff.
I'll hold it.
Oh, yeah. You have the staff of fire.
I have to put that ring, the wand on.
Yeah, staff of fire, wand of the war mage, the mask. So...
Why can't that just meld the staff and the wand together to make one super magic item?
If only it worked like that. Right. I think Ozan has the least amount of attunements out of everybody.
No, I got 3.
Are you at
3? I have like 1.
Yeah, you never. Right. We still never transferred my Cloak of the Bat.
Oh, right. You have the Cloak of the Bat. So there's Cloak of the Bat. What else do you have? The
Link Dagger and the Elemental Blade.
Right.
I thought you didn't have the Link Dagger anymore, so. Oh, well, you do? Never mind. I'm stupid.
It still might work out.
I am low-key salted at my roles for the shop. Everyone gets these mystical shit, and I get offered potions.
You have a curse on a portable hole.
Hey,
no, I remembered about the portable hole. I was so fucking distraught about the potions, I forgot about it. I actually wanted to go back and get that, or find out the price at least.
Portable hole?
Yeah. I'm always down for some shit that I can use to break the way shit works.
Why does it matter? Okay. So the charge of an atom, why does the neutron matter? Oh, god damn.
Because neutrons matter,
the
okay?
Portable hole.
Just so you guys know, that's literally a black hole.
Yeah, it's badass.
Yes, I know.
No, that shit's really useful.
Yeah, no. I meant to get it, but I forgot because of the fucking bullshit.
No. The Sphere of Annihilation is a literal black hole.
Oh.
In reality itself.
Oh yeah, that thing.
It just destroys.
A question on.
The portable hole was, at first, he is requesting 9,000 gold for it.
Mm-hmm. Talk that bitch down.
I said, you can try to talk him down.
Okay, we'll use that same speech of nigga. I forgot you're streaming, fuck.
It's all good.
Question on.
What's up? Bitch!
Same rolls first. Jesus Christ.
How many times are you going to roll 5 tonight, Tyson? What's up, Tyler?
I don't know. How many more potions am I going to be offered?
About 5 more.
I was going to ask, where would the instrument of the bard show up in my character sheet under in my inventory?
It would be in your inventory. I haven't added it yet.
Ah, okay.
I'm going through the stuff as we go here.
Good to know.
Unless anybody want to spot me on this black on this portal hole,
I ain't got you. How much you need? I got money.
1, 2. If you need it.
How much you need?
Tyler, you will need to attune to the instrument of the bars, by the way. So keep track of how many items you have attuned, because you can only attune to 3. Okay. So the sunblade, the instrument of bards. Is there anything else?
No.
Yep. Okay.
If I get a dragon mask, well, it's mine.
So the only person that could actually attune to the ring is Otto.
Realistically, I could drop my
cloak. Do you need the fire staff? Does the fire staff not suck?
Free fireballs?
Ah, okay, yeah, that doesn't suck.
I should say wait, fire? Ring of fire?
Yeah, that definitely doesn't suck.
Yeah, no, that staff of fires.
See, Otto already has
also
healing.
It's a very rare item. This thing would probably sell for 50k gold.
Well, yeah, I have healing, but I only have mage.
Oh my god, I can sell the staff and get the Sphere of Annihilation.
Alright.
I'm gonna go back to the trader.
Yeah, I only have cure wounds for healing. It's kind of eh.
I can free up a slot real quick. Hey, dude, you wanna do a trade?
I mean, I would like to trade with people. Apparently, my potions sell for 50 fucking K.
Malkar, give me a persuasion check.
Guys, give me a nat 20.
I believe.
Fuck the 10.
18.
It's only 18.
He would offer you 100% of its base price, 40,000 gold.
Ouch.
So he's only going to buy my staff of fire for 10 gig gold?
Scam artist alert.
Yeah, he would offer you 40k for the staff.
Oh, I was only
40k.
If I didn't buy the other two items, I could get the Sphere of Annihilation.
I could buy you some money if you need it.
In reality, it would take another week to sell the Staff of Fire, but you could sell it.
We don't have the time.
You could sell it if it came down to it. As the four of you.
Next time we're in town, we'll come get that.
The second week.
There won't be a next time. Not in this campaign.
The second week begins to wrap up. It's the four
Wait,
of you.
I never. After my persuasion, I never got told what the price of the hole was.
You wanted 9,000, you rolled a 5. Tell you what, I can give it to you for 7,000.
Alright, how much will you buy an oil of etherealness for?
Give me another persuasion.
I swear to fuck!
Don't roll a 5.
Can you roll a 4?
Jesus! Fuck,
I asked you not to roll a 5. I didn't mean that.
Oh my god.
Oil of Etherealness is a rare potion. Best I can personally do would be 2,000 gold.
I'm pretty sure the other ones are this big!
I wish you knew cheap ash from somewhere really far off. So he just can't see me.
I was offered like... Nick. Jesus fuck.
We need some money. I can buy you like 5k.
I feel so bad. You think you can cut this whole session.
Tyson shopping next week?
It's okay. It's okay.
I want this. The hole is basically like just opens up a space like between like walls and like shit like
it's
that.
It's literally
right?
Like the cartoons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really want that because we could break a lot of shit with that.
You can use an action to unfold a portable hole and place it on or against a solid surface, whereupon the portable hole creates an extra dimensional hole 10 feet deep. The cylindrical space within the hole exists on a different plane, so it can't be used to create open passages. Any creature inside an open portable hole can exit the hole by climbing out of it. You can use an action to close a portable hole by taking hold of the edges of the cloth and folding it up. Folding the cloth closes the hole, and any creatures or objects within remain in the extra dimensional space. No matter what's in it, the hole weighs next to nothing.
Does that mean you trap a person in there?
You could catch Graham White in that and just bring him back, rip off his mask.
How great would it be to capture one of the heads of the cult?
I know, right?
We would get nothing for that. The council?
We would get nothing for that, though.
Let's see who's really under this mask.
I really do want the fucking portable hole.
Maybe somebody can spot you.
There was actually something on my list.
Okay.
How much do you need, Tyson? Seriously. How much do you need?
Wait, let the seller talk real quick.
Okay, all right.
What he's about to say.
Listen, I can't go any lower than this. It's what I personally bought the item for, and I'm trying to make a profit. I'm sure you understand. But I can give it to you for 5,000.
5,000 is fair enough. I'll sell him the fucking thing, and I'll give him 3,000 gold.
Okay. Alright, so you'll essentially trade one Oil of Etherealness and 3,000 gold for a portable
hole. Yeah.
Okay.
If we can tell you to go into your hole, like, when you're mad.
Alright, there's your portable hole, buddy. And, now...
At least I have a fun fucking toy to play with now. Everyone else got fucking toys. I wanted one. You're gonna show up wearing armor like an idiot.
I wanted that star, the robes of the stars so well, bad.
It was a look what I got. I got a belt. There it is.
Look at my sunshine. For my sunboy.
As the four of you are heading back to the inn to call it a day, being the last day of your 2-week downtime, Ozan, as the four of you are walking back, you would catch someone waving you down.
It's fine, Clay. You don't gotta do it.
Oh no, I've had this prepared since the beginning, buddy. I've had this prepared since the beginning.
God, this. Whenever this happens, you just gotta put your hand to get like next to your face and just keep walking. Don't talk to strangers. Keep walking. No, I'm kidding.
You say that after we literally met magic vendors in fucking back alleys.
Yeah, all right.
He's opening a code package for you.
I go to him.
Well, You can't exactly tell what gender it is until you get close. As you approach, you see between... Well, you can sort of make out by the shape of the robes that it's a rather feminine figure.
Alright. Ambiguous.
I take it that your time in the city has not been pleasant when it comes to the shopkeepers.
They're not my strong suit. I'm not very good at bartering.
Don't worry. Neither was I at one point in time, but... well, you pick up a few things here and there as you go along, and... well... let's just say that you do have friends that will be keeping an eye out for you. I hope that this is something of useful to you. And she hands you a scabbard. You see a hilt. It does appear to be a longsword of some kind.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, we will catch up later, I'm sure. For now, you have a world to save, my friend. Think of this as a gift from our kind.
Okay, I thank you.
You still had a sunblade in your pocket.
Or are you just happy to see us?
Exactly.
God. What did he get?
Alright, Tyson.
What was that?
Which one do you think it is?
Lightning sword, actually.
Well, it depends. What does the hilt look like? I mean, like, what does the scabbard look like? That would tell me a lie.
You see the scabbard sways back and forth.
There it is. It's a motherfucking Levin sword.
What, that Thunder Fury Blessed Blade of the Windseeker?
Yeah.
It might as well be. It might as well be, John, which is why I found it so fucking hilarious that you memed on me with Thunder Fury Blessed Blade of the Windseeker in your shopping list. What Ozan now has is a Thunder Sword, also known as the Levin Sword. The blade of this sword was forged in the shape of a lightning bolt. When you hit with a melee attack using this magic weapon, the target takes an extra 1d6 lightning damage. In addition, you can use your action to shoot a bolt of lightning from the blade. You make a ranged spell attack against a creature within 60 feet as an action. The spell attack for this effect is 8 plus your dexterity modifier plus your proficiency bonus. Creatures must make a dexterity saving throw to take half of the 3d6 lightning damage.
Damn.
I am now Lightning Snake.
You're a danger noodle.
You strike like lightning?
I'm a nope rope. I'm not...
He is quite literally a nope rope.
It's kind of funny how I just have like 3 swords that attach to my hip. And fucking longbow on my back.
And with that, we will go ahead and wrap up tonight's session. We've been live for 3 hours and 13 minutes, so just over our 3-hour allotment. I figured this session would be a lot of time spent in town. I figured there would be some role play, a lot of shopping, and things of that nature, and I had already decided that I was going to give each of you at least one shiny new toy.
Thanks, Papa Clay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ozan, I had to quite literally hand it off to Ozan, though, because you just got dicked on every roll.
God.
All everyone else, I was able to incorporate it in that. Oh, here's a shiny new toy you can buy. But then Ozan just kept getting dicked over and over and over.
Wait, his literally potions every time.
I'm gonna pull Ozan aside and point him to an address on a map and tell him we need to go get everything from this guy.
Yeah, I got like
that new shiny item of his.
I got extremely fucking lucky, even going with, like, open one, not doing shopping. Oh, here's something I want.
I rolled insane. Well, he rolled insanely for me, which I appreciate.
Yeah, like, oh, look, an instrument of the bards. I'll just take that from you. It's mine now.
Like, I feel bad getting it because it's like, I didn't want to just be handed it.
I know you didn't, buddy, but I had already decided that each of you would get a shiny new toy.
You tried, okay? You tried, but, you know.
But you failed miserably.
Apparently people know I'm, like, doing shit with potions.
Let's go to the graveyard and just collect
potion?
Shit.
Potion? Potion? You buy potions, yes? You buy potions. Buy my potions.
What the fuck?
The potions.
I have two supreme healing potions. You need these, yes? Yes, yes, yes. You buy. Bye, 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 bye.
Supreme healing potion. I didn't buy her the first guy. Why the fuck would you make me do?
So, Oak, did you ever take Arcadius' crown from him? Or did he keep that?
I don't remember.
Boss, you can't have my crown.
Well, you still have that thing.
You can't have my crown, boss.
It's all right now. We're kind of done with all the buying and selling shit. It's a bit late.
So you mean I get to keep my gold and diamond encrusted crown?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you can keep it for now. Till I need it.
But it's mine.
Yeah, whatever you say, mate.
They made it for me. Come on, boss.
Whatever you say, mate.
I'm honestly wondering, how the fuck would...
By the way, the crown that is on top of Arcadius' head is probably worth, like, 100,000 gold.
How much? Again? I heard a number, but I didn't hear the qualifier.
Two spheres of annihilation?
Oh! How much is it worth, Clay? One more time?
It's probably worth, like, 100,000 gold.
You fucking what?
Go to the seller.
Okay, hold on. Oak's an idiot. Yeah, you could probably keep your bait.
Thanks, boss!
That's expensive, Oak. That's an expensive thing on his head.
That's fine.
I am now bashing Oak's head against the wall.
I have no idea why you're doing this to me, but I'm feeling nothing.
I grab the portable hole and tie it around his neck.
You know, this isn't really nice, is it? This isn't really nice, is it?
I'm gonna try and get it from just Arcadius.
You'd never catch Arcadius.
Also, can you motherfuckers stop minigaming, please? Thanks.
No. Damn. Never.
I feels bad.
I feel.
Don't, my friends, because I do have one last thing for you, Tyson.
This is for me. Yeah. Oh wait.
Oh no! Believe me, none of you are gonna want this. As you settle in for the evening, it's been quite a while since any of you have had any sort of visions or prophecies.
Oh, God.
Ah, son of a bitch!
Fucking Ogma.
Ozan. Fuck that. You find yourself surrounded by your people.
Ah, shit.
Surrounded by Yon-Ti.
Ah, shit!
The initiation running for
you. Oh, fuck! I knew it was gonna happen.
Sort of hissing and looking at you.
My god wants me back.
Welcome home, brother.
Brother, it's been too long.
That is where we end tonight's...
Oh, okay.
That is where we end tonight's session.
He rejoined his people, the sewer snakes.
The sewer snake! Yeah, when you said, like, fucking... When you had her talking shit, I was like, fucking hell, no! Don't involve this!
Like I said,
left that life behind me for a life of knowledge.
Unfortunately, if your vision, if your prophecy is true, it's coming back for you.
Yeah.
I will kill him. Whatever.
Yeah, just kill him for it.
Exactly.
I know you managed to talk down an army of lizardmen, but can you really talk down an army of Yonti?
I doubt I'll talk to them.
Well, I shall try to stick them in the stomach.
So who is going to take the Ring of Spell
and then
tyranny?
Get stuck.
Who's going to take the Ring of Spell soaring, by the way, and attune to it? Is it going to be Tyler, or are you going to give up your bat cloak for now, Tyson?
They could. What would we put in it?
I feel like we got like a strong healing spell or something.
We would do a bunch of healing spells. And you, honestly, you end up. You're pretty squishy, Tyson. So I think you should probably grab that. I'd say drop the bat cloak and I'd fill it with. Or me and Tyler, depending on.
Would
we'll
I give like almost everyone
shit.
Like. Yeah, because I think either me or John.
I'm thinking we'll do. Yeah, well, John can because he has a.
Well, yeah, but I'm just saying like. So then we have three out of four people with healing spells. Like,
yeah, exactly. So I'm thinking we'll do one level 2 cure wounds and 3 level 1 cure wounds if it doesn't have anything else, which it does. So go ahead, Clay.
All right, then yeah. Tyler, want a bat cloak? You can transform into a bat. You get advantage on stealth rolls when you're in dim light or less. It's actually pretty good. I should have utilized it a lot more.
Let me check my stealth. I have a +6. I could use that. It just depends. I'm very held on to it. Depends if I'll use it.
It's pretty good. You also can, like, fly with it if you're in dim light.
Mm.
Well, I think it's more of, like, gliding, but, you know.
Yeah.
Alright, so.
Hold on to it. If we get a mask, I'm going to drop something. Probably that.
As you attune to the Ring of Spell Story, let's see here.
It's hilarious because I lost that class feature in my when my class got updated and now I have it again.
Let's see. All right. Can I get you to give me a percentile, please, Tyson?
All right.
I can wait till.
Did I go through?
Yes. 22.
Oh, yeah. Map was covering it a little bit.
Okay. Can I get you to give me a... another percentile? Okay. And then... can I get one more? Six. Okay, and give me two more percentiles this time.
Okay.
Oh, this is gonna be something. Okay, 98 and a 14. Jesus Christ. One more percentile, please.
14. Hello? This is
scary as fuck.
Yeah. Nuke? Hello? No, thank you?
Oh, another 94? Okay. In that case... oh, no, that's... don't open that. Close that. Over here. Okay, and then 94 is... where is it?
Okay, Tyson, Malkar, I have a question for you guys. Just, like, for in-game in general thing. When I get the diamond dust in-game, would you want me to ward your, bag of holding, Tyson, and your mask, John. Sorry.
For what?
Alright.
From what?
So...
one second.
The ring... can hold 5 levels worth of spells at a time. As you finish attuning to it, you see that the ring currently has one charge of Revivify.
Oh!
Oh! You fucking what?
And... so it has one charge of Revivify, one charge of Expeditious Retreat.
That was not as good, but still cool.
Which essentially, bonus action concentration allows you to take the dash action as a bonus action on subsequent turns.
Allows you to yeet your way out.
Pretty much.
I can become a rogue.
Exactly. And then one charge of... give me another... percentile, please.
Clay, how many percentiles?
I got tables. Lots and lots of tables. I have lots and lots of tables.
First we roll what kind of school, then we roll what kind.
You don't understand the number of tables.
I can't open up the glyph of warding window.
I can. I think if you click the little shield, it should be able to.
Yeah, no, I'm saying I can't do it.
That is odd. Huh. Yeah, essentially, just, I know the mask is important, and like the bag of holding is important. I could just pretty much put a spell on it or an alarm on it, so pretty much nobody besides us can touch it. It'll do 3d8 damage per, what, like, if you want, like, an explosive spell, like, hold on, let me read it. One second.
I don't think that we want that in a bag of holding.
Well, no, like, if, like, you can definitely grab it, like, you'd be able to grab it yourself, but
like nobody else can try and snatch it from you, or else it'll do a
blow up.
Well, no, it'll do like a area around you, but it won't. I don't think it'd destroy the item like that it's on.
No, it would destroy the bag.
Would it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's why I was wondering. Maybe that or alarm sort.
What would destroy the bag? Sorry.
Glyph of warding.
Putting a... Yeah.
Yeah. You can't mix too many magic things. It's carefully balanced in each item.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
You don't have multiple enchantments on one item.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of, like, doing the ward. Maybe a alarm spell, or... Not an alarm spell.
Tyson, the other charge within the ring currently... So there is Revivify, Expeditious Retreats, and one charge of Commands.
Oh.
Which totals up to 5 levels.
Alright, that's total 5?
Yeah, one third level spell and 2 first levels.
Revivify is the third level?
Yes, it is.
Or... Okay.
Yep. And Commands and the other one are both first levels.
Tyson.
Yeah.
Where are you putting the portable black hole?
Not in the fucking bag of holding!
I was gonna ask you for that, actually.
Just checking.
Nigga!
I was waiting to make sure.
Slightly opens it. Shit. Which hole am I in?
No, you pull
up. No, thing everyone is gone. Well, no, it says it opens up the astral plane.
You're not gone. You're just in the place where gods go to die.
Oh, sounds like the high school restroom that I used to, the restroom of the high school I used to go to.
So,
place that gods go to die.
Since you guys are all still in Fantasy Grounds.
Oh, are we done?
Yes.
Okay, bye.
Next week.
Here.
Next week, you begin the long, long journey.
I am
feel
scared.
Real bad for those guys still in Trollbark Fortress.
I'm real scared, guys.
So, should we go after Varum, or just go to the sea-moving ice thing?
Guys!
Right, we should go to the dragon worms.
Guys, we have other scaly things that are after us that are not dragons!
Where are we making a check, though? The tradeway? Oh, God.
You are going to be going to...
Subar? Fubar?
The south one.
All these ones were north.
Scornuber?
No, you'll be going to Bereskir Bridge. Which is near... Serpent Hills and Forest of the Worms. So you'll be going there.
Oh god, it's off the map, guys.
I know. I'm scared.
As a matter of fact...
I'm trying to murder my mouse.
Oh, you know, if you fit it to your screen, I'm pretty sure you can scroll down far enough.
Exactly where that arrow is pointing is where you're headed.
It's the crack.
Where? I love cracks.
Serpent Hills, that's not very...
Why are we going back
to people, huh?
Oh, wait a second. Serpent Hills? That sounds like a place where Yonti would be. Wow, and then he had the dream.
Right,
I wonder what we'll fight. More frog dudes. Pog.
Barum's gonna get that. We're gonna get that match from Barum.
I'm gonna say, Tyson, did you just put two and two together, my friend?
Oh, I already I was already knowing that what was gonna fucking happen.
Quick, turn the boat around.
Please tell me we aren't gonna find a vampire there.
I'm sorry. We're fine.
No more vampires. I hate vampires. So much.
I would like to become a naga again. Can we go with the original? Can I be from the sea?
Never.
You, my friend, are a Yanti. Through and through.
I should have stayed steadfast to me being a fucking naga. I should have held strong to that one.
So you guys, if you're gonna be heading to the south to investigate Varum the White, you can cover 24 miles a day. It's gonna be 2 to 3 weeks to go from Waterdeep to Boresker Bridge.
Sounds fun.
Question.
On land or water? I'm sorry, you land. Probably said it. Okay. Can we just say, could we like maybe get a boat to make that faster? Like go to basically the way we came. Well, not the way we came, but maybe to Baldur's Gate and then go up maybe? That would be faster?
That would
take way too long. Okay.
Oh yeah, because we had the fucking Fields of the Dead and shit to worry about.
Yeah,
fuck
you remember
that.
How fun that place was?
Yeah, let's just walk.
I gotta say, would you like to go through Fields of the Dead and Troll Claws again?
Yes, Clay, I would love to.
Troll Claws twice, even.
Did you take a trip to the Troll Hills?
See, we just cut through the Fields of Dead.
Yeah, just go right through the Trollbark Forest.
I accidentally stumble upon the liches later and come as minions.
Oh, I see Daggerford. Yeah. Remember that for some reason.
Yeah. There's a couple of things that you can do.
Probably gonna have to drop this command spell out of there.
Just go ahead and use it to make Oak do something embarrassing.
Command sucks.
Oh, go grab the
it has to be one word.
Yeah, I was gonna say it has to be one word.
Dance.
Oak strip. Dance. That is great.
Strip. Okay. Dance. That's funny too.
Dance the dance of your people.
Dance of my people is different from dancing.
My question.
That would be me cutting you in half.
So I'm a smork. Orc.
Yeah, I'm a smork though. I'm a smorkidon. That this my people a, cut people in half.
This is a random question, but like I'm looking near Neverwinter, and like over in the sea, there's this, like a little island thing. I was wondering what that was. Couldn't tell though. It's just a random piece of land.
Over near Neverwinter.
Yeah, like if you look directly left of it.
Don't worry. One day you'll find out what that is. Don't worry.
That's Team West Fortress. That becomes
one day you'll find out.
I think I know what that is. If it's a thing.
What do you think it is, John?
We don't want to go... Correct me if I'm wrong. Isn't it kind of like a pit in the ocean?
I mean, I know of several of
those. And there's only one thing that lives there?
Gonna say,
the mighty Leviathan.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
It has many ways to it at the bottom. Many ways you don't want to come from. The one thing is a Tarrasque.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and wrap up the stream and then probably hang out for a couple more minutes before I pass out because I have to be up at fucking 10 a.m.
Now, do we want to do any...
We can do a few episodes, but I can't be up too late.
Yeah, probably just better off wait.
Yeah, like I can do like 2, maybe 3.
I'll catch you guys later.
See you. Alright, later.
Alright, thank you guys for watching. We will be live on hopefully Saturday. at twitch.tv/ABBYY for Tyranny of Dragons, I Want to Die Edition. It's essentially the same campaign that we played tonight, but with a different group of people, and a slight twist. This group is much further ahead. They have started on the Rise of Tiamat. And then we will also be live Saturday evening with Prince of the Apocalypse, with my good boy Oak, as well as a couple of others. After that, it'll be a break on Monday. We should be back and live on next Tuesday for Humble Beginnings. Then next Wednesday, we'll be back here at 8:30 p.m. Eastern for more Tyranny of Dragons, The Chosen. Thank you guys for joining in and hanging out. Everyone has a wonderful evening. Unfortunately, I don't get to pay as much attention to chat as I would like when I'm DMing, so I'm sorry if I don't answer questions immediately. Just know that I am occasionally looking over to chat, and if I do see the question, then I will answer as soon as I possibly can. You guys have a wonderful evening.